Again, the tailback misdirection, and Hunter is stopped just about at the line of scrimmage. Play was read very well by Michael Johnson, 42, the weak side linebacker, the sophomore out of Lee High School in Midland.
And the Tech defense has played extremely well thus far, except for the personal foul penalty.
Second down, 9 coming up. Brett Stafford, a quick conference on the sideline with head coach Fred Akers. Russell Hayes, the senior from San Antonio, splits out wide to the left side as Brett Stafford, who has hit for 338 yards in the air, is going to go back and try on second and 9 and gets it away. It is almost intercepted. It was intended for Hunter. Johnson had the coverage. A flag was dropped, but that's a pass that should never have been thrown.
And it appears that Texas will be getting the penalty here from the reaction of the Tech players.
So the call will go against the Longhorns. Texas with a 4-2 record overall, opened the season with a win over Missouri and then beat Stanford in a wild game. Texas then dumped Rice 44-16 in the Southwest Conference, lost that squeaker to Oklahoma 14-7, and then defeated Arkansas in a major upset 15-13 at Arkansas. And then, of course, last week, SMU really unloaded on the Longhorns. Got a holding call against Texas, costing him 10, back to the 32. Here are the officials, Dixon Holman and his associate, who are working today's game. Second down, 19, coming up for the Longhorns of Texas as Gene Chilton moves up over the ball. Three wideouts to the left side, and coming in motion now is Norris. Pursuit is on as they blitz. Hastings coming through the middle, gets blocked, passes away and incomplete. Russell Hayes, the intended receiver. Jones had the coverage on the play, and with the middle linebacker Hastings coming on a blitz, he was almost clipped in the backfield.
Stafford did a great job here. As we see Hastings, the linebacker, coming right with the snap of the ball, but it was a rollout pass, the bootleg, and Stafford was able to get outside of the blitz, get the ball off downfield. The excellent pass coverage, however, is there to break it up.
It'll be third down, 19, coming up for the Longhorn. Had an illegal forward pass. And we have a loss of down on that. So let's run up the down to third down and 19. Check that, third down and 24 now for Texas. Third and 24 coming up for the Longhorns. Texas Tech has won twice here, 1955 before they become a member of the Southwest Conference, and then in 1967 as a member of the league. 1913 they won. And Stafford stumbles, coming out of the backfield, has blockers, throws on the run, and let's go to be a question. Now it is a reception on the 14-yard line. Completed to Russell Hayes. Oh boy, 23-yard pickup on the play. Carter was over there on the coverage, and watch Hayes stay inbound.
I questioned as the play started whether he was going to stay inbounds, as we see Stafford dropping back and then breaking to the outside. That takes away the blitz rush. He's on the run, throwing the ball. And let's take a look at Hayes' feet now as he stretches for it. He's out there, and he definitely is in. No, he was not. He was out of bounds without any question.
It is fourth down and 2. Johnson is now the fullback, and the handoff goes to Darren Norris. Darren Norris bangs his way down to the 10-yard line for a first down. Brad Hastings, the middle linebacker, 44, stopping the play.
The officials don't often make mistakes, but that was one allowing that completion to Hayes. That Tech has got to just be shaking their head and say, how long are we going to be snake bit?
Gary Moore's going to head for the Maylocks when he sees that one on film. First down on the 14, Jerome Johnson has come out. Russell Hayes and Everett Gay are in as the wideouts. On that last play, Texas brought in two fullbacks. So Hayes splits to the left side, Gay to the right side. First and 10 on the Tech 14. Stafford goes to the tailback Hunter, and Hunter is dragged down at the 7-yard line. King Simmons, the free safety, the senior from Killeen, with help from Scott Davis, 94, a senior out of Plano, gets the tackle.
People who follow Southwest Conference football closely believe that Simmons is one of the truly great defensive backs in the league, and a man that has a great future.
It'll be second down, and the ball is set on the 7-yard line. Second down, goal to go. Johnson is in there. They go to the power eye. Two fullbacks to the ball game. Johnson is up front, and the pitch comes to Darren Norris, and Norris following his blockers gets inside the five at about the three, and Tim Crawford stops him after he picks up four. Tim Crawford, number 92, the defensive left end.
Very good blocking by the Texas team, and also a marvelous job of ball carrying. Watch how he kind of watches the blocking develop, then does his little jitterbug in there, finding a small bit of daylight to pick up the gain on the play.
Third down and goal on the three. Fred Akers and his Texas Longhorns come out of the power eye again. Norris is the tailback in the power eye. Johnson in front. They go. This time it is Brett Stafford keeping the ball after a good fake to Darren Norris, and Stafford goes in untouched. Excellent job there by Brett Stafford.
And a very good call. Power eye formation. You expect the power backs to be used. Stafford made a good fake. Texas Tech took the bait. He was able to go into the end zone untouched.
Now the extra point try by Jeff Ward. Ward perfect on 14 attempts this year. And the kick is right at the middle, but a flag is dropped on the play. Danny Akers holding. It looks like Ward was a man who got belted. Texas going in front by a score of 7-0, and now we will get the penalty marked off on the kickoff.
Watch the excellent faking of Stafford here as he rolls out. You can see the Tech man moving in, making the tackle, and the man who did not have the ball, Stafford keeps it, moves into the end zone easily. One more time. Watch the fullback being tackled. He's hit by three men, and Stafford has the ball, goes in cleanly for the score.
So Texas is on the scoreboard first this afternoon with 8 minutes and 32 seconds to go in the first quarter. Longhorns lead 7-0.
Who know it's how you play the game. Yeah, just for you. That distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
So, Texas Tech being penalized 15 yards on a personal foul call on the extra point by Jeff Ward. And now the Longhorns will kick off from the Tech 45-yard line. You know, Bud, I've never quite figured out. A penalty like this really doesn't penalize the offending team because the kicker is just going to kick the ball out of the end zone, presumably anyway, and the ball comes out to the 20, so what's been gained or lost?
There'll be chances. They might use an onside kick because the ball is far enough downfield that even though they do not get the ball, they could force the other team back deeply enough that they would be in trouble anyway. But I think that he'll kick this one away. Although the way he's setting up, it might be an onside kick try.
Ooh boy, it's going to be interesting here. Yep, you called it, Coach. And the ball's got to go 10 yards, but it goes out of bounds. So it'll go to Texas Tech on the 34-yard line. The ball will come to the 34. That's where Texas Tech will put the ball to play. They have the option, the ball going out. I can't imagine that they would want the ball kicked over, however.
So they will not, I'm sure.
Yeah. So the Red Raiders get the ball. Pretty good field position at the 34-yard line. Illegal procedure call is against Texas and obviously declined as Tech will take the ball at the 34. So Jerry Moore, who had a week off after a heartbreaking loss to Rice, a couple of balls dropped right at the end of the ball game, now hopes his Raiders can put it together as Chris Tanner comes up with the ball, and the quarterback is Aaron Casilla there in the wishbone. Handoff going to Ansel Cole, and Cole is popped down at about the 37 by Brian Espinoza, number 94. He picked up 3 yards on the play. Espinoza filling in for the injured Steve Llewellyn. the sophomore defensive left tackle, who is, in fact, was up here with us a little earlier today. He's on the injured list today.
And the double counterplay did not fool Texas. So Texas has a man in every gap every time the ball is snapped defensively.
Texas in the 4-3, and they've got those holes pretty well filled, as you see there. As Cassie on a drop after play action throws incomplete, and the intended receiver was Bruce check that. It was Ricky Boyson, number 88. And it was Gerard Senegal on the coverage.
That was a good call. They need to throw on early downs to get Texas off balance. Cassie is back, delivers the ball, beautifully bounced out of the hands. It really was good enough. One of those things that has just plagued Texas Tech. The balls are on target. The receivers just do not seem to be able to hang on.
Tyrone Thurman split wide to the left. Look out for him. He's 5'2", but can he move it? Nope, they're going to stay with a run, and up the middle goes Isaac Garnett, and he doesn't go very far as Chalmers Adams, 96, and Blake Groner, 85, the right tackle and right end, respectively, for Texas. Stopping, and it's fourth down for the Red Raiders.
And they have yet to make a first down.
Fourth down, four. Punting unit is on. Robert Grimes to kick it away, and Eric Metcalf is back deep for the Longhorns. That ball hanging up high, kicked into the wind, coming out of the north at about 20 miles an hour. Fair catch call for by Eric Metcalf, the son of the former All-Pro Terry Metcalf. A 33-yard punt and no return. It'll be Texas ball on the Longhorn 27-yard line when we come back. Longhorns lead 7-0.
So this is Beverly Hills, huh? Guess I'll get used to it. A rodeo skull rodeo. And the best hotel is pink. I'm checking in, they're checking out. My machine is standing out. What's the matter with y'all? Ain't you ever seen a truck?
Beverly Hills Truck. The hero has arrived.
Stay on top, quick feet.
Oh, that's good.
Man, I tell you, now that's tough to get the hang of.
So is that smokeless tobacco, Walt.
Go long cut? Nah, it's real easy. Let's give it a try. Long cut means it packs easy, so it stays put between the cheek and gum.
Not moving around?
Yep, the skull long cut makes it real easy to enjoy tobacco without lighting up.
Got a nice taste to it.
And it comes in wintergreen or mint. Easy to use, great taste. That's go long cut.
It's as easy as falling off a log. Walt?
Remember to stay tuned for the end of the game when Bud and I will be picking the Dodge player of the game. That'll be coming up near the end of today's game. That's the story to date. 7:25 to go in the first quarter. Texas in possession. Longhorn 27-yard line. And the quarterback is Stafford. Two wideouts left and right. Texas expected to run today. And Jerome Johnson, the fullback, getting the handoff and going to the 32, where Michael Johnson, the weak side linebacker, who is a 205-pounder and a very hard hitter, makes the tackle. It'll be second down and four.
Most of the time in the I formation, the ball is going to be pitched back or handed back to the tailback. Fullback can hit it quickly. Johnson almost found a lot of daylight on that play.
4-yard gain, I should have said. Second down, six. As you noted, the Longhorn band has got their raincoats out. A little miss falling right now. Stafford can throw. He goes long, and it is caught. That's going to be a touchdown for Everett Gay. Everett Gay, a 69-yard bomb. He had a big against SMU, 5 for 83, and a big loss. However, this could turn out to be a big win for the Longhorns. Everett Gay, his first touchdown reception of the year, a 69-yard strike. Jeff Ward for the extra point try, and the Longhorns take a 14-0 lead.
Very good job of seeing the ball here by Gay, but it could have been an interception. Watch the Texas Tech defender come up, and he almost picks the ball off. Then the ball bounces out of his hands into Gay's hands, and it's just smooth sledding into the end zone. And once again, they're rushing the kicker on the extra point. And, there was no reason for that contact whatsoever, but they did make contact with the kicker.
So Texas scores quickly, and it's 6 minutes and 41 seconds to go in the first quarter. The Longhorns lead Tech by 2 touchdowns.
What a great evening.
I hope it's not over yet.
Look, I had to tell you, right now, I shouldn't be doing this. I'm a married woman.
That's okay. I'm a married man.
Happily married?
Very happily.
Oh, me too.
Well, happy anniversary.
Stephen, it's beautiful.
An anniversary ring of fine quality diamonds, the gift that says you'd marry her all over again.
What is Jefferson Pilot? I don't know. What is it?
It's a breakdance done to the tune of one of our radio stations. It's a welcome check delivered by one of our insurance agents. It's Bill Martin's retirement home, made possible by our financial services. And it's the big game broadcast over one of our TV stations. Jefferson Pilot is many companies, all helping to put a brighter face on the future.
Everett Gay has caught his first touchdown pass of the year. Brett Stafford has thrown his first touchdown pass of the year. 69 yards, the ball tipped off the hands of Carl Carter. I want to tell you, Carter closed that gap pretty well, though, on Gay, even with Gay's speed.
He really was looking for the interception all the way and just misjudged the flight of the ball.
Now Ward to kick off. Wayne Walker, Keith Henderson back into the end zone for Tech. And the ball will be brought out by Keith Henderson. Henderson to the 17. That's as far as he gets. Tackle made by Pawalik.
Texas plays their defense fairly straight up. Defensive linemen play head up with their offensive opponent, but then they always shoot one gap or the other, one side or the other side of each of the offensive players, and then the linebackers fill the other gaps so that they have every gap covered when the ball is snapped.
Tyrone Thurman split out wide to the left side, double wing, double wide outs, double everything. One running back, motion man, everything in this play, and the ball is handled by Cassie, and he really takes a jolt near the 20-yard line by Britt Hager, who wears a very famous number 60. Who wore that number before? Tommy Nobis and Jeff Lighting.
Number 60, Britt Hager.
Britt Hager from Odessa Permian, sophomore. 6'1", 218. Second and seven coming up.
And Tech needs to get their offense on track. They have yet to make a first down.
Again, they spread the offense. Man in motion, handoff going to Isaac Garnett, the fullback, the freshman from Midland, stopped by Chalmer Adams after a gain of four. Check that number. Give him 5 yards on that, if you will. Adams, senior from Waco. Third down, coming up for Texas Tech.
Pass formation that time with the two wingbacks. Wingback picked up in motion, opened up a little daylight for Garnett on the straight wishbone, handoff to the fullback.
Third down, three. Again, they use a motion man. Throwing, it is completed to Ferris coming out of the backfield, and Ferris has the first down of the day as Ty Allard, the strong linebacker, number 48, and 42, Richard Peavy, the free safety, stop him, but it's a gain of 12, first down Raiders.
And number 42, Richard Peavy.
The man in motion, Ferris, as he goes out, Cole. And now move downfield, and that's a little bit of a pickoff there, as you can see him riding through two defenders, and the pass now wide open, of course, because of the movement of the motion back.
First down just across the 35. That play doesn't go any place. Garnett is ducked behind the line of scrimmage. He got back to about the line of scrimmage. Chris DeLobin, number 39, the weak side linebacker from Springwood High School in Houston. We'll get that tackle. Timmy Smith is missing from the Texas Tech Red Raider offense, and it really hurts. They counted on him a lot this year. He's had knee surgery, this junior out of Hobbs, New Mexico, and boy, does that hurt the Raider offense.
Can't afford to lose a man of his caliber. Injuries are such a vital factor of the success of any football team.
Nickel defense now for the Texas Longhorns with five defensive backs to cover as Cassie throws. It is completed. It is completed to Wayne Walker, a big play man, and look at this big play as Walker gets into Texas territory at the 40-yard line before Stephen Braggs, the left cornerback, can pull him down with help from Richard Peavy, the free safety, and it's first down for Tech.
Beautiful execution as he drops back, sets up, he has plenty of time, no pressure. Fitz Crawford wide, wide open, and you can see the speed that he has as he breaks past, got a nice block from the flanking back out there, picked up a beautiful gain on the play, and Texas in business.
Again, it's Cole in motion to the right side as the Raiders are on the move. They go to a draw with Garnett, misdirection, down across the 40 to the 39, and Blake Brawner, number 85, stops the play after a yard pickup.
And if they can get their pass attack consistently moving, they'll get themselves back in the game in a hurry. Their running attack has not been good, but so far Cassie has thrown the ball with very good accuracy and has had excellent protection.
James McGowan has also been on the injured list. He missed two ball games for personal reasons, and he is in uniform today, but he is in there right now, so he's in for the first time today. Second down, 9 coming up. Ooh, a blitz. Chris DeLobb in the weak side linebacker gets to see before he can all get out of his tracks. He's got him down at the 45-yard line for a loss of 6.
When you feel the blitz coming, the receivers have got to stay in to pick him up, and you can see he goes untouched. Linebacker, Dillabin, on Cassie before he has any opportunity whatsoever, but a mistake on the offensive blocking.
Third down, 15 at the 45-yard line of the Longhorns, who lead 14 to nothing in the first quarter with 3:08 to go in this first period. That's Cole in motion to the right side. Screen intended for the little guy, Tyrone Thurman. Now we got a flag on the play. After the play was over, Tyrone Thurman, who is only 5'2 and weighs 128 pounds. They list him at 150, 160. He weighs 128. And he was out there as a wide receiver screen, but it did not work, and let's see what the flag's about.
Getting the officials ruling here, and it's unnecessary roughness. I think they hit Thurman after the ball had clearly been thrown and was an incomplete pass. Take a look at it. You can see it happen. Here's Thurman, little juke downfield, then step back, get ready for the screen. The ball bounces out of his hands again, and McKinney pops him, not a little hard, and I think one of the reasons McKinney did hit him was he was not positive that was not a lateral pass and would have given him a chance to recover had the pass been a lateral. It was a forward pass, however, and a tough penalty against Texas.
That's a dead ball foul and a major penalty, taking ball down to the 30-yard line where Jerry Moore's Red Raiders, who trailed 14-0, 3 minutes to go in the first quarter, and the Red Raiders finally putting their offense together. Isaac Garnett is in at fullback. Eddie Anderson is down as a wideout to the right side. Cassie. No, sir. I don't know about that one. I don't believe they made it. Ansel Cole stopped by Chalmer Adams on that fourth down play. And they did not make it, apparently. They did not. It is now signaled first down, Texas.
And that was a marvelous defensive play and a great disappointment. Had Tech been able to just pick up that little bit of yardage, as we take a look at it again, you can see it was a little counterplay. The Texas line overpowered the offensive thrust of Tech.
Looked like Chalmer Adams, 96 on the bottom of that pile. Brett Stafford, who threw his first touchdown of the year, touchdown pass, goes to the run on this first down to Charles Hunter, the tailback, who is chased out of bounds at the 35-yard line by Tim Crawford, number 95, the defensive left end. A gain of 5, second and 5 coming up. Charles Hunter has scored 3 touchdowns rushing this year, and going into the ball game had 339 yards. And you mentioned, Bud, I know you had a nice conversation with Fred Akers yesterday. He really likes Hunter, doesn't he?
He thinks that the improvement on his team is all of the running backs are so much better than the backs he's had in previous years. Same time, he doesn't think that his linemen are quite as strong as they have been.
Second down, 6. The pitch going to Hunter. Hunter tries to make something the hard way and maybe gets a yard or so before Tim Crawford, 92, the defensive left end, who leads the tackling along with Larry Mathis, number 96. In there, gain of 2. It'll be third down and 4.
All coaches are looking for a balance between pass and run, and Texas has the best balance that I recall hearing at this time of the season. They've made 1,055 yards rushing and 1,057 yards passing. Only two more yards passing than running.
That's Michael Johnson, the linebacker of Tech, getting some medical attention. James Johnson has replaced him. Good play action there. Pursuit is on. Pass thrown and caught. First down, 48-yard line. Everett Gay, who caught a touchdown pass of 69 yards on the last Texas possession, is brought down by Carl Carter.
Stafford is a very impressive quarterback as we see him roll out here. Gay is broken downfield and then comes back. And you can see that there was not much the Tech defender could do because he had broken so deeply downfield when he turned and came back toward the line of scrimmage, he could not get in front to block off the pass.
Horns have a first down, their own 48, a minute 53 to go in the first quarter. They're leading by two touchdowns and a fumble recovered, however. Jerome Johnson fumbled the ball and looked like McCray fell on top of it. Calvin Riggs, number 35, is a defensive player. And that's Tim McCray, 81, who made the recovery.
Looked like they were trying to run the option play there. He let Stafford read, as triple option teams do. That time he gave it to the fullback.
Second down and 10 coming up. A minute 24 seconds left to go in the first period. The Longhorns lead it 14-0. Russell Hayes puts wide to the left side, Gay to the right side for the Horns. This is the tailback, Charles Hunter. Hunter gets into Tech territory at the 46. And Brad Hastings, the middle linebacker, and King Simmons, the free safety, stop the play. You're going to hear us talk a lot about Brad Hastings on tackles today and all-conference selection last year. Consensus all-conference selection, leading the team in tackles with 113 out of Bowie High School in Arlington.
And he's got the great credentials physically. 6'3", 235 pounds, and excellent speed.
Third down, three. Gay to the left side, Russell Hayes to the right side. We have a timeout called by Texas. And it looked like Russell Hayes called the timeout. I think he got the note from the bench. Timeout. So it is. 35 seconds to go in the first quarter. Texas ahead by two touchdowns.
Toyota gets the big jobs done. 26 55-pound payload, 5,000-pound towing capacity. 4x4s with the most powerful gas turbo engines on the road. And 4x's with the maximum mileage off the road. Toyota truck prices start at just $59.98. No wonder the most satisfied truck owners are Toyota truck owners. Who could ask for anything more? See the number one small trucks at your Toyota dealer today.
Give me a light. Bud Light. Oh, the chili.
If you just ask for a light beer, you never know what you'll get.
Give me a light.
Bud Light. So if you want the less filling light beer with the first name and taste, don't just ask for a light beer.
Look, give me a light. No, Bud Light.
Bud Light. Because everything else is just a light.
Well, this is college football. What we were talking about at the start of today's game. Lots of excitement on Saturday afternoons and evenings around the country. Third down conversions. Tech, as you see, 1 for 4. Texas, 2 out of 3. And Texas has a 3rd and 3 right now. 35 seconds to go in the first quarter. Oh, going to get a movement penalty against University of Texas. Tim McCray, who's the tight end, jumped the gun.
We can take a look at this again, and you will see how McCray jumps offside, just moving a little bit ahead. Bottom right side of the screen, number 81. See him as he moves there, and you see the rapid reaction of the Tech team. You're taught defensively to go against movement, and that's why Tech has been a good defensive team, because they do react very well.
Third down, 8 coming up. Stafford to the sideline to talk to the coaching staff. 14-0 Texas. We're in the first quarter at Memorial Stadium. Got a few no-shows today because of the rain, but they sold over 74,000 tickets. Stafford under the gun, being pursued. Hastings on a blitz. He gets that pass away, however. And let's see what we find out about that. Harris, the tight end, apparently did come up with a reception. Boy, what a play that is. We're blinded by the Texas bench. We'll see it now in the replay.
And they've done a great job on these third down passes. If you see Harris come off the line of scrimmage, duck by the linebacker so that he's not held up, then break it to the outside. Stafford scrambling, throwing on the run. And that was a great throw and a great catch. Almost impossible for anyone to do anything to stop the pass because you can see him coming back at the ball, diving for it, and then cradling it in to make the reception.
Gain of 14, first down Texas. Nice going, guys. Great replay. Here's a handoff going to Charles Hunter, the tailback. He is down to the 32-yard line. Brought down by Brad Hastings, the middle linebacker, 44, and Larry Mathis, 96, the defensive end. A gain of 5, and it'll be second down 5 coming up, and we have 9 seconds to go in the first quarter. Charles Hunter, the sophomore from Odessa, Texas. 3 seconds. We've had our last play in this first quarter. So the first period comes to an end. Texas leading by a score of 14-0 on Brett Stafford's 3-yard run and then his 69-yard touchdown pass to Everett Gay. And we'll be back after these messages from your local station. It's Texas against Texas Tech, and this is the Raycom Sports Network.
100 years ago, long distance was simple. You gave your message to a Pony Express rider, and he took care of it. Now, due to the new long-distance rules, you're going to have to choose your own long-distance company. Or somebody's going to do it for you. You'll want to make up your own mind. When you choose Clay Desta, we're going to take care of it for you. Clay Desta Communications. Give us a call.
Welcome to 1986. Your Dodge dealer wants to thank you for making Dodge the fastest-growing American car and truck division. We intend to keep it that way with revolutionary cars and trucks. Check out the new optional equipment discount packages that can save you up to $850. And our 5-year, 50,000-mile protection plan comes with every car and truck we build.
Catch the great deals now at North Point Dodge, I-35 at the St. John's exit.
Second quarter coming up at Austin, Texas. I'm Merle Herman along with Bud Wilkinson. And let's look at the time of possession. It seems like, Coach, that Texas had the ball longer than that. Away.
Well, they had those quick touchdowns, which helped them, but I thought they had the ball longer, too.
First down on the 32, or second down, rather, on the 32. And Texas goes to the run. It is Johnson still trying to find something, and what he finds is a horde of white jerseys. The primary tackler is King Simmons. He had a lot of help, though, so Jerome Johnson did a lot of running. Roland Mitchell should also get some credit there for the tackle. Jerome Johnson from Pilot Point, Texas.
And he battled his way hard enough to pick up the necessary short yardage to make the first down on the play.
So it's at the 27, and Darren Norris comes in as fullback now. Jerome Johnson goes out for the horn. Over the ball, Gene Chilton, Jaton and Chester the guards, Houston and Stewart are the tackles. Metcalf is now in as a wide split to the right. Oh, he's in their tailback, I guess. Now, here's a handoff going to the up man, and that's Darren Norris. And Norris gets down to the 20-yard line where Larry Mathis makes the tackle. Sometimes we'll see Eric Metcalf, number 2, and you'll see him in a moment. Little Eric Metcalf sometimes will come out of the backfield and become a flanker. He's not very big. He's only 5'9", 178, the freshman. But he has really excited some folks here in Texas. He certainly excited them in the first game against Missouri on a big punt return. Second down coming up for the Horns. Now here is Eric Metcalf. Let's see what he can do. He's got a first down inside the 15.
He's got that priceless quality speed in addition to great balance. Take a look at it again. Gives you some idea of this young man's ability now and the future potential. See him break it upfield. Then that acceleration to break through the gap and then bouncing off, almost shaking off the last tackle. First down on the play.
Throw the ball down at the 13-yard line. Texas leading 14-0. Norris the up back. Metcalf is the tailback in the eye. Fullback gets the call. Norris from El Camino, California, gets down to about the 11 where Brad Hastings, the middle linebacker, is there to make the stop. You know, Brad Hastings ought to be all world the way he has played this year.
Fine football player, and Stafford is setting up the option play. He's been giving it to the fullback thus far, but one of these times soon he will fake that play, keep the ball himself, turn up field or maybe pitch it to the trailing back. The player set it nicely.
You saw part of the Akers family, father and son, and Danny Akers gives the signs, the hand signs, to the quarterback, and Metcalf goes right up the middle. Metcalf gets inside the 10 near the 8. It'll be third down coming up after a 3-yard pickup. Third down 5. Desmond Royal, who is now in right tackle for Texas Tech, makes the stop in the play. Did his dad play for you with the St. Louis Cardinals?
No, he did not. He had gone to Canada before I got there. I was very disappointed, however.
Red Akers' record, 9th year, was an assistant, 9 years to Darrell Royal here before going to Wyoming as the head coach out there for a couple of seasons. Brett Stafford, the option, he's going to keep it, and he struggles for the end zone, but he won't make it. He gets down to about the 1. King Simmons will get credit for the tackle. It'll be first down and goal to go for the long run.
And Stafford had this very well set up. He's been faking to the fullback. This time you can see him make the fake and how cleanly he breaks it up the field. The secondary is the first people to touch him, and he almost got it into the end zone, but was forced back about, maybe a foot from the goal line. But a beautiful execution of the option play after having it well set up by the previous calls.
And you just saw a Longhorn bulldog to the ground by the Red Raiders. First and goal to go. They go into the power eye. The up man is Jerome Johnson. Norris is the tailback of that power eye. It's Jerome Johnson for the touchdown. And the Longhorns go up 20-0. So the Longhorns are starting to make it a very long afternoon for the Red Raiders of Texas Tech, and we're only in the second quarter by a little bit. Ward, the extra point try. Ward is now, let's see, he's perfect this year. And he is perfect again this afternoon. That's 3 straight for him. And it's 21-0 Texas with 11:46 to go in the first half.
And taking a look at the touchdown. Beautiful blocking. When you can make that kind of a hole on the goal line, you know that your offensive line is executing with precision. Let's watch it one more time and see there's the lineman fire out. The double team on the guard, the outside, the center block to the left. Wide, wide open.
So the Longhorns are ahead by 3 touchdowns here in the second quarter, just barely in the second quarter. We'll be back right after this.
Most people know you can only buy a Curtis Mathis at a Curtis Mathis Home Entertainment Center. They know delivery and installation are included, and there's a 4-year limited warranty on every product. But what people don't know is just how long a Curtis Mathis really lasts.
Oh, well, time to get another Curtis Mathis.
Yep.
At Curtis Mathis Home Entertainment Centers, our products may be a little more expensive,
but they're worth it.
More than telephone service, the Southwestern Bell Network is the messenger of the information age.
Our plan was to reduce costs by creating a paperless claims system. We connected doctors and hospitals to our computer through a data network designed for us by Southwestern Bell Telephone. And it works even better than it did on paper.
To put information into motion, call Southwestern Bell Telephone. We're online with the future.
Texas leading 21-0. Bad news for the Longhorns, though. William Harris, who made that diving catch near the near sideline, remember that one a little bit ago? He injured his hand. He may return, but right now they're not sure. 187 total yards for Texas offensively. 50 for the Red Raiders. Jeff Ward to kick off. Keith Henderson, Wayne Locker are back, and that's a ground ball type of kick that is going to go to Gerald Bean, and Bean comes up to midfield and across the midfield stripe and down to the 47-yard line.
Number 36 receiving that kickoff.
Let's look at other ball games as Maryland leads North Carolina 14-0 in the second quarter.
Boston College, Penn State looks like a ball game.
Second inning.
And Syracuse not expected to beat Pittsburgh, but was expected to be close games. It proves to be Clemson leading Wake Forest. And Michigan State is bombing Minnesota.
Wow. First down, Red Raider 48-yard line. And two wingmen going to the run, and the handoff goes to James McGowan, the fullback, and he is near midfield as Kip Cooper, number 90, who's now playing the defensive left end, makes the stop. Georgia leads Tulane 10-0 in the first quarter.
And Oklahoma State, Colorado is expected a very close football game. LSU leading Mississippi a little easier than I thought they believed that it would be.
Second and nine for the Red Raiders. Chris Tanner over the ball. Man in motion is Bean going out to the left. Cassie on the drop. And throwing on the run, underthrows the receiver at the 41-yard line. It was Tyrone Thurman. Stephen Braggs had the coverage on the play. And coach, about one more series, and I'm going to start looking for Billy Joe Tolliver to come in at quarterback for Texas Tech. Remember what he did against Rice? He almost pulled that game out in the last minute with two passes, two long passes, one an apparent touchdown pass, which is dropped to the end zone, but he's got a rifle arm. So right now it's going to be Cassie, and he sends Thurman wide to the left side. Split to Winglin, right out to the right. One running back, Bean in motion. Cassie to Tyrone Thurman on the wide out screen, and hey, that ball's got to be thrown just about on the level of the number, or he's not going to be able to jump to get it. He's only 5'2".
That ball was thrown maybe just a little bit too hard. As we take a look at Cassie, as he drops back, rolls it out there to Thurman, and it's got so much velocity on it. Thurman, a little bit high, had to go up in the air for it and couldn't quite hang on.
So once again, Robert Grimes in to do the punting and drives it downfield, and the ball is going to roll toward the end zone. Will it get in? Yes. Last minute takes a bounce, gets into the end zone. A 51-yard kick by Robert Grimes, who was averaging 38.7 coming into the ballgame. Texas leading at 21-0. 10 minutes, 50 seconds to go in the first half. And with Texas on top by three touchdowns, we'll return after this.
Delta gets you there. To Los Angeles. Boston. Chicago. And New York. Also service to all of Florida's major resorts. Delta also gets you to Europe, Hawaii, and the islands. In all, Delta serves more than 100 cities in the U.S. and overseas. Delta gets you there.
Tolliver with a golden arm is starting to warm up for Texas Tech. He's a freshman from Boyd, the red shirt last year, had an outstanding senior in high school. He's a best thrower on this Tech ball club.
When you're this far behind, you got to put somebody like that in the game.
And now, Eric Metcalf. Metcalf breaking one tackle, almost getting away to the outside across the 25 to the 26 before Merv Skurlark, the sophomore from Monahans, can make the tackle. A gain of six, it'll be second and four.
He's an interesting football player with that tremendous burst of speed.
Second down, four for the Horns. Splitting wide to the left side is Gabriel Johnson on a second and four call. Stafford goes to Metcalf, hops up over the would-be tackler, gets near the 30, just a bit short it would appear. Warren, the strong linebacker, makes the stop. He's out of Monterey High School in Lubbock.
Very clean tackle, too. Beautiful execution by Warren.
Third down and that much. Texas has converted four times out of five on third down situations. They show the power eye. Johnson and Norris. Make that Hunter. And they've got the first down on the run with Darren Norris, Tim Crawford, 92, the defensive left end from Cashmere High School in Houston. will get the tackle there.
Power eye on short yardage gives you that one more blocker that adds to the problems of the defensive team, and that set up, of course, the touchdown for Texas when Stafford faked and then kept the ball himself.
Johnson is out of the ball game as a wide receiver, and Monty Daly is in for Texas. Well, let's see. Johnson is still in there. Johnson and Daly. It is Jerome Johnson. And on this misdirection, it is Charles Hunter. That's pretty good play action there by their quarterback, Brett Stafford, and Leonard Jones, their overback, has to make the tackle. Good deception of the backfield by Mr. Stafford.
It's the first time that they have run a true counterplay. Tech has been reacting quickly to the side of the first fake. They were certainly set up.
Johnson wide to the left side for Texas on a second down. 8:38 to go in the first half. Texas leading it 21 to nothing. It's time the fullback, and that is Darren Norris again. Norris has the first down to the 45-yard line. It's Doug McKinney, the middle linebacker, number 57, the senior from Sherman on that tackle for Tech.
This Texas execution of the offense has been so far very excellent, as you can see them just blowing everybody off the line of scrimmage. The ball carrier finds it easy when the line blocks that well and the outside linebackers take the fake, knowing that they've got to be aware of Stafford on every play.
So it is a first and 10 for Texas. Pitch goes to the tailback. But Hunter gets to the midfield stripe. Charles Hunter, who has scored 3 touchdowns this year for Texas. Leonard Jones are over. Again on the stop. Stafford is doing an excellent job of running this Texas offense. Bruce Blackmer, who was into the ballgame for a couple of plays, comes out, and Paul Jaton comes back in to replace him at left guard for the Horns.
I've been impressed with Stafford's ability to throw the football. He's executed some excellent passes.
Daly to the right, Hayes to the left for the Horn. Just shy of the midfield stripe on second down. Hunter to the 49. A couple of yards. James Johnson, the weak side linebacker. Dynamite himself makes the tackle. Bud and I are watching the Texas band on monitors supplied by Curtis Mathis. Curtis Mathis, a little more expensive, but worth it.
Almost a defensive blitz on the last play by Tech, and they need to be committing more people to stop this running attack.
Third down, just across the midfield stripe. Texas leading by a score of 21 to nothing. And we've got a timeout call for the Longhorns as Brett Stafford comes to the sideline. And 6:59 remains in this first half here at Memorial Stadium in Austin. Texas leads Texas Tech by a score of 21 to nothing.
This Halloween, don't just ask for a light beer.
Bartender, please, give me a light. No, Bud Light.
Bud Light, because everything else is just a light.
Now, how about if I tweet?
Make this Halloween a Bud Light Fright Night. Look for this display with free poster and special mug offer at participating retailers.
Me? I'm an accountant.
If he sinks this putt, he wins the tournament.
Hold it! Can anyone here name a copier maker that's bigger than Ricoh?
Xerox.
Ricoh's bigger.
IBM?
Ricoh's bigger. And we got to be bigger than Xerox by making a full line of copiers that win top marks for quality.
Illuminating.
Now, are you still overlooking Ricoh? Call Ricoh. We respond.
That's a gimme.
Merle Herman and Bud Wilkinson with you in Austin. Here's the total offense for the first half, and to say Texas is dominating would probably be the understatement of the year.
Tech had the one shot when they failed to make on fourth and a yard in good field position.
The way Texas has operated is Stafford now carries on the option, is yanked down on a tackle by Scurlock before he could really get big yardage. He got enough for the first down at the 42-yard line, make that the 43-yard line, and it's first down Horn.
Stafford has set up this option very well by handing off to the fullback on the first 3 or 4 times that he made the fake. That time, he faked the ball to the fullback. The Tech defense closed and let the opening come up for Stafford to break it downfield and pick up a first down on the play.
First down, 43-yard line. Texas leading 21-0. Johnson and Daly are the wideouts for the Horns. Stafford, they countered back to the left side. Metcalf out of bounds on the 34-yard line. He gets about 9 on that play. It'll be second down 1 coming up. And Carl Carter makes the tackle.
And this Texas line and backs also are beginning to get great confidence in their blocking. You can see the three linemen pulling on the right side of the screen. Metcalf turns it upfield, then breaks it to the outside, runs through one tackler before he is knocked out of bounds and picks up about 9 on the play.
You know, a moment ago, we saw Bebo head on. That must look like that Texas offense coming at Texas Tech. You're wearing white shirts today.
Three wide receivers this time, unusual.
Stafford, second down. They stay on the ground and get the first down. Darren Norris, the freshman from El Camino, California. Larry Mathis makes the stop for Texas Tech. Danny Akers with his father, and watch Danny now give the play, or he will shortly.
You put three wide receivers out and short yardage play. And Texas hasn't shown that formation very often. You defensively are always tempted to, let's just assume they're out there to fake me and just don't cover them, but that's too great a risk.
First down on the Tech 31. The tailback, Hunter, no place to go up the middle, tries to get to the outside, and the Red Raiders will not let him turn the corner. A fine defensive play by Leonard Jones, the Roverback, who strung him all the way to the sideline and kept Johnson from getting to the outside for big yardage. You got 3.
Watch the play again as Stafford hands the ball off this time to Hunter. Hunter tries to get it up inside, but there's no daylight there. The pursuit stays on the proper angle, and Jones makes the tackle. A very excellent defensive play by the entire Tech team.
Second down, 7. Pursuit. It's a word coined by University of Oklahoma when Bud Wilkinson was coaching there. The handoff. And Darren Johnson, the fullback, up the middle across the 25, down to the 24, and Tim Crawford makes the stop after a 4-yard pickup.
Take a look at some of the blocking on the offensive line. Chilton, the center here. You can see him taking off zone blocking. He picks up the linebacker, knocks him off very well to set up the play. It was Hastings that he hit.
Coach, didn't that make you happy? I remember one of your slogans at OU was, if you make one block and you're satisfied, go get another one.
That's the only way to do.
Third down. Stafford does not get the first down.
It's a game where the old saying goes, you either hit or get hit. And if you're getting hit, you're losing. If you're doing a hitting, you're winning.
Fourth down for the Longhorn. 21-0, Texas. 4:59 to go in the first half. And it's fourth down, less than a yard for the first down. Danny Akers signals the call out to quarterback Brett Stafford. Oh, something's wrong. They're in the wrong formation. They had 12 guys on the field, too. That's the wrong formation. Power eye to the right. Hunter hit behind the line. I don't believe he did it.
A little bit of confusion in the offensive backfield, and that's all it takes to destroy a play.
So Brad Hastings makes the tackle to stop Texas and also stop the Longhorn drive. Red Akers upset because of the non-execution.
You lose the starting count timing when you have to delay because of delayed substitutions, and you lose the permanence of the formation getting set in your stance and ready to take off to attack the defense when you were as late as Texas was in setting up for that play.
Billy Joe Tolliver, Mr. Saturday Afternoon, is now in the field as the quarterback for Texas Tech. Billy Joe, draw nothing there up the middle, swinging to the outside is McGowan, and McGowan gets a first down. It was Tony Tilden, the right quarterback, who finally got him down, but James McGowan headed up the middle, nothing there, did a good job going wide.
And everyone expected on the Texas team, Tolliver, to put the ball in the air, so that was an excellent call.
At the 37, first down for Texas Tech. Billy Joe Tolliver, the freshman at quarterback. Tolliver with a big arm. He's going to crank it up and let it go, and does, and it is caught. It's caught by Bouvier Dale out of the backfield, and he is down to the 18-yard line, and Stephen Braggs, the left quarterback, and Tony Tilvin are there, and that is a first down on the 18 and a 45-yard pickup.
And as you mentioned, Tolliver has got a great arm. Dale is out of the backfield. Good protection, and Oliver really gets rid of this ball, and look how long that ball is in the air. Dale comes across out of the backfield, makes a good reception, then reverses his field, cuts back against the grain, gets a little better balance to pick up the big gain on the play.
That's Tolliver's first completion of his collegiate career. Tolliver, who ran well as a high school quarterback, gets to the 15, and that is all. Kip Cooper is there to make the tackle.
And Texas did a very good job of ignoring the inside fake. I thought that Tolliver would set it up because that's the first time, really, that they've run the option.
Tolliver had thrown the ball three times, twice in the last minute, you'll recall, in the last seconds, in fact, against that loss to Rice. Tolliver, uniform shirt out of the pants, reminds me of Bobby Lane. You listen, Bobby? Tolliver blitz, gets the pass away, Dale out of the backfield. Dumped at about the 10-yard line by Bragg. Gain of four.
Dropped the ball, but he was clearly on the ground. As we take another look at the play previous, we see Tolliver set back quickly. He's rushed from the outside, but he gets rid of the ball knowing that the receiver, Dale, is going to be open with that many men blitzing. Fumble, but you can see that he was on the ground before the ball bounced loose.
Third down three. Billy Joe Tolliver, 6'1", 190 pounds. He looks bigger than that, doesn't he? High school last year, passed for 1,093 yards and ran for 924. This time he pitches, and they don't get much on that one as Gerald Bean is crushed to the turf by Mark Petkovich, the middle linebacker from Nimitz Galdine. And Jerry Moore likes what he is seeing so far from Mr. Tolliver. It'll be fourth down, however, from the 11-yard line, and they've got to go three more for the first down.
And they had the sweep that time from the wishbone formation using all the blockers rather than have the fullback fake for the ball.
Boy, so now the tight end sets to the left. They split one man to the right side and are in the full wishbone now on fourth down. Billy Joe Tolliver, options, pitches. First down and more, and down to about the 1-yard line goes Bouvier Dale.
Tolliver is extremely impressive. You can't execute the option any better than he does on this play. Seemed to down the line. There's the pick to the fullback. Tolliver keeps, pitches the ball at the last moment, and it appears that it's going to be into the end zone. Texas, however, recovers quickly to knock the ball carrier down on the 1-yard line.
James Lott and Stephen Bragg saving that touchdown, and now the Texas Tech Red Raiders are on the move, but they also call timeout. Texas leading at 21-0 with a minute 40 left to go in the first half, and they have the ball first and goal to go at about the 1-foot line. Well, you're looking at Billy Joe Tolliver. Tolliver, you know, one of the things the coaches have said about him, Bud, is he doesn't look good in practice, but he keeps telling them, "Coach, I'm a Saturday ball player."
Well, most of the time you go with the people who look good in practice, but when you're as young as Tolliver is, seniors are always going to look a little bit smoother in practice because they've had the experience. But Tolliver certainly thus far on this drive looks like a game football player.
You had some guys, though, along the line that were pretty good game day players that weren't that impressive in practice, though, didn't you?
Well, you always do. But after they have impressed you in games, you get them in the starting lineup the next time around.
So Billy Joe Tolliver has Texas Tech down on the 1-foot line with Texas on top by 3 touchdowns. Boy, that tipped pass and reception by Everett Gay for 69 yards in a Texas touchdown looms so large now. Here come the Raiders, first and goal. Billy Joe, touchdown. His first career touchdown.
And that's the way to climax a drive. Take it over yourself.
I don't think he'd let anybody else take the ball, do you?
Well, it's the safest play in football, particularly when you're that close to the goal line. You're not going to risk anything by handing it off to another back. Beautiful execution by Tolliver as we see him go off the field.
So he marched the Raiders down the field in a hurry. Now the extra point try by Mark Mallory to come. Tannehill will do the holding. He's a quarterback. Mark Mallory is 11 out of 11 on the extra point tries. And there's nothing wrong with that one.
It's good.
So a minute 37 seconds remains to be played in the first half. Texas leading at 21-7.
Watch Tolliver here. You can see him slide off on the right side of the offensive center, who got a good job blocking on the guard and putting the ball in the end zone. Now we see it from the side again, and see how he moves to his outside quickly. And the center drove off, completed the play for him. And Jerry Moore has been waiting this for quite some time. He's looking at it intently, and that's not a lot of exuberance, but believe me, inside, you're feeling a tremendous amount.
Well, it took Tolliver seven plays to take the Raiders 78 yards. Minute 37 to go in the first half. Texas leading it 21-7, and we'll be back right after this.
Unmistakably hot. Unmistakably cool. Unmistakably sharp. Unmistakably smooth. Unmistakably right.
The enemy, rain. A mere 1/8 inch can float your car off the road. Thus the rationale for Vector, Goodyear's unique all-season radio. So advanced, its crisscross tread actually pumps away water to help more tire and your car stay on the road. The Goodyear Vector. It simply performs like no other tire in the world.
Hoden to Billy Joe. You know, he's the kind of a kid, Coach, that appeals to me. He says, give me the ball. I'll take him down the field. And so he does 78 yards. He's got just enough cockiness to give him that supreme confidence that he can move the ball. And he did. Eric Metcalf wisely downing the ball in the end zone.
Texas has lined up looking for an onside kick. Metcalf was all by himself. Fortunately, he was wise enough to keep it in the end zone rather than try to bring it out.
Long boomer by Scott Segrist. Wonder if his daddy Cal is watching today. Old friend, at the 20-yard line, it'll be Texas ball, first down. Bet his daddy's here. Minute 37 to go in the first half. Texas 21, Texas Tech 7. Brett Stafford has done an excellent job of running the offense for the Longhorns today.
And Texas thinking fumble.
Metcalf.
Metcalf, two,
right up the middle for about four.
And the scoring drive engineered by Tolliver was excellent. It only took him seven plays to move the ball 78 yards.
Now we're down to a minute 17 seconds to go in the first half. Second down is the call. Wideouts to each side for Texas. 1 minute left to go in the first half. Eric Metcalf trying to spin off a block and cut back to the inside. Gets to the 30 and he may have the first down. Carl Carter, the All-American candidate, the right cornerback, who will no doubt go very high in the NFL draft, makes the tackle.
Hey, fella!
Tolliver, he can't wait to get back in there, but he may have to wait till the second half to do that.
But he's going to be looking forward to it. And that touchdown that they scored will give Jerry Moore something to talk about, particularly when he reminds them that the pass was called complete when the receiver was out of bounds, and also the deflected pass that set up the other Texas touchdown.
First and 10 on the Texas 30. Texas stays on the ground with a run, working the clock with 28 seconds to go. A gain of two on the play as Mathis puts the hit on, and we're down to 22 seconds and counting. Texas leading by a pair of touchdowns and extra points, of course. Texas, I don't believe, is going to run another play. We're down to 9 seconds. So the Longhorns will take a two-touchdown lead into the locker room at the half. And on this misty afternoon at Memorial Stadium in Austin, Texas, Coach Fred Akers and his Longhorns, who are going for their third win of the year in Southwest Conference play, are leading by a score of 21-7. Well, Coach, a guy like Tolliver, the way that he operated that offense, Texas had better be aware of his potential in the second half, don't you think?
I know they will be, but the key thing is going to be, can Tech stop Texas on their first possession. If they can, they're back in the game because they're only two touchdowns behind, and two of the Texas touchdowns were, I'd say, kind of fortunate plays. Hayes was definitely out of bounds on that pass that kept the drive going for the first touchdown, and then the deflection of the pass to Gay was just one of those things that happened. Could have almost been an interception. Instead, it's touchdown Texas.
But Texas Tech went flat after they got those two tough breaks, and Tolliver, it looked like, really rejuvenated him.
No question about it. He came in with the type of leadership that you hope a quarterback can bring to a team.
So it's 21-7, Texas leading Texas Tech in the Southwest Conference game in Austin. And we'll be back after these messages from your local station. This is the Raycom Sports Network.
Now at Burrow Building Materials, we'll put savings into your plan. Check your circular in Sunday's paper for savings like this Robert Shaw Setback Thermostat for guaranteed year-round energy savings, just $59.99. Add traditional charm with the solid brass Williamsburg chandelier, just $99.99. And to seal gaps and cracks, Thompson's Easy Insulator Foam Caulk, just $1.99 after your $150 mail-in rebate. More savings in your circular. Save now at Burrow Building Materials.
Don't do it yourself without us.
Burrow.
Are bad brakes sneaking up on you? If it's been 20,000 miles or a year since you've had your brakes checked, you're overdue. Putting off your car's brakes can be costly. So come to Brake Check. We'll check your car's brakes, steering, and suspension free. We not only check it free, we do it right. And that makes a difference. So get a free brake check at Brake Check before it's too late.
Love Car Care Center is a quality service center. They carry quality Uniroyal tires, like this Uniroyal Royal Seal radio. It's a puncture-sealing, all-season steel-belted radio with a free replacement road hazard warranty. Love Car Care Center at Uniroyal. Quality you can depend on. Know how I know? I know quality when I see it.
KBBO-TV, Austin.
What you know is important. So is who you know. I feel like that getting to know people while you're in college is something that's going to influence you the rest of your life.
Well, my favorite thing about Texas Tech is the career choices. Law, medicine, engineering, agriculture, and fine arts. More choices than any place in Texas.
And learning is easier when the professor really cares. One of the more striking things that separates Texas Tech from other universities is its air of friendliness that's perpetuated by the faculty and staff and the rest of the students.
I'm a grandmother who has felt right at home here at Tech. I couldn't ask for a friendlier group of students and faculty.
I've stayed long enough to finish my doctorate.
Texas Tech University, beauty from the inside out.
From Lubbock back to Austin, Texas, and here's the going band from Raiderland.
Thank you.
At halftime, Texas leads Texas Tech by a score of 21-7. Red Raiders scoring with just a minute to go in the first half.
This is the average family most financial plans are made for. But at Pilot Life, we know families are made of real people, not statistics. That's why Pilot Life representatives never take an average approach. All people differ. Their goals, their problems, their needs, and of course their dreams. That's why no two Pilot Life financial plans are ever exactly alike. And that's why they all work.
Them in the showroom.
Texas, 71,000 miles of highway and over 3,200 towns and cities, and no one covers it like Central Freight Line. Truckloads, packages, big business and small, Central's been serving Texas reliably for over 60 years. Now in big cities like Dallas and Houston, you've come to expect that kind of service.
And in a town the size of Gun Barrel City,
well, you can expect it too. Central Freight Line. We're loaded with pride.
Curtis Mathis wants you to hear what you're missing without Curtis Mathis Stereo TV. Half the sound. Curtis Mathis has a complete line of new stereo TVs, consoles, big screens, and components, all unlike anything you've ever heard. But there's no way to show you that on your old TV, so come listen to the only stereo TV backed by an exclusive 4-year warranty. Curtis Mathis Stereo TV. She's great.
Greatest of the Great is presented by the Jefferson Pilot Companies.
Imagine playing football for 4 years in college, setting records in five different offensive categories, but at the same time winning only four of 44 games your whole career. Well, Mike Renfro did just that at TCU from 1974 to 1977. How does he describe it?
That was brutal. We went to TCU knowing that it was going to be an uphill battle, and I personally thought that we would continue to improve our athletic play year in and year out, which obviously we didn't do very well, and we ended up losing 40 football games in 4 years, so it was tough. My personal pride and dedication to the game was something that was real strong within me, and I continue to try to improve myself week in and week out, and fortunately it's paid off, but it was a tough college career.
But it made Mike Renfro a very tough football player. In 4 years, he set school records for touchdowns receiving, total receptions, and yardage that still stand today. Although he is proud of those achievements, he feels that it is only a matter of time before someone comes along to break them.
Traditionally, the Southwest Conference has been a rushing offensive football power, and I've been out for 10 years now, so I'm somewhat surprised, I guess. They're made to be broken, and I feel definitely that they all will be broken, but I'm happy to hold a few records still.
Drafted by Houston following his senior season, Renfro began what has turned into an illustrious NFL career. But after some strong seasons by the Oilers, he faced some more lean years.
It was deja vu the last 2 years in Houston for me, and I'd been there before, and a winner never likes to lose, and it's something that you don't get used to if you are a winner, and I didn't get used to it, and I was thinking about giving up the game. It got so bad there for a while.
But he didn't, and today he is still catching passes in Texas, now for the Dallas Cowboys. And in fact, this year he has a chance to set an all-time personal record for receptions in a season, along with playing for a winner.
I'm very happy to be in this type of atmosphere, the winning tradition, and being able to contribute to the offense. For years, it's been a very successful offensive style of football. In Houston, we gave it to Earl Campbell 3 out of 4 plays, and he got the job done for us, and we didn't have to worry a whole lot about passing the ball, so I wasn't catching a lot of footballs down there. But it's fun to be contributing and catching the ball here, and and playing in this winning atmosphere.
Greatest of the Great has been presented by the Jefferson Pilot Companies.
At Delta, we could talk about our airplanes, some of the best-maintained, most modern birds in the sky, or our schedules, over 1,500 flights a day worldwide, or our flight centers, the airports of the future. But none of that is as important as people. And when it comes to the Delta professionals, the people who make Delta as great as it is, well, one smile is worth a thousand words. Delta gets you there.
You know, when I started dipping Kodiak, made my friend here real happy because it's his brand. Now it's my brand, too. It's good and moist with a special cut that packs right, and it's got a big, fresh wintergreen flavor. But don't take my word for it. Just ask my friend here. He's really got away with words, don't he?
When you want cash discounts on great gasolines, who's got it?
Gulf's got it!
Who's got low self-serve prices?
Gulf's got it.
And when you want credit card convenience, who's got it?
Gulf's got it.
Cash discounts plus low self-serve prices for extra savings and credit card convenience. Who's got it all?
Gulf's got it. Gulf's got it all.
Everybody wants a trouble-free car, but these trouble spots can affect your vehicle and the cost to maintain it. Toyota owners tell a different story. Every year, the leading consumer magazine compares vehicle repairs from almost 500,000 owners. Once again, owners of Toyota, cars, trucks, and vans reported the fewest repairs, making them the most trouble-free. Better than Nissan, Honda, Chevy. Get more trouble-free driving at your Toyota dealer now. Who can ask for anything more?
Texas leads Texas Tech 21-7 at the half. Earl Herman and Bud Wilkinson with you. And Coach Tolliver really put some spark into that Tech offense.
Well, he put them back in the game, and if they can stop Texas on their first possession, Texas will be back in the game. They had two very bad breaks. Gay was out of bounds on a pass that they called completed for 21 yards, and then the deflected pass to Gay could have been an interception by Carter, and it became a touchdown for Texas of 69 yards.
This could really be an interesting second half, couldn't it?
It's going to be great, and Tolliver maybe can keep it going.
Okay, let's check scores for the ball games now to see what's going on around the country. And Maryland is leading North Carolina by a score of 14-3. That game is now in the third quarter.
And Boston College and Penn State remains close. Looks like the baseball score, as we mentioned a moment ago. Syracuse continuing to lead Pittsburgh, and it's now in the third quarter. And Wake Forest being beaten solidly by Clemson in the second quarter, and Minnesota is putting back some points on the board. They were behind 31-3 at one point. And Georgia rolling over Tulane. And Colorado leading Oklahoma State, which would be a surprise if they can hold it. Georgia Tech and Duke in the second quarter, 0-0. And South Carolina against North Carolina State. That one's closer than expected in the second quarter, and LSU continues to lead Mississippi.
And so our game here is 21-7 Texas, and we'll be back with more of Southwest Conference action right after these messages. Texas 21, Texas Tech 7.
At the University of Texas at Austin each summer, we introduce 600 of the brightest high school students to our Honors Colloquium.
I came to the Honors Colloquium because I was aware of the fact that UT ranked among the top in the country in the number of National Merit Scholars.
You can't have simply a good program. You have to have good teachers. You have to have good students. And that really makes the place.
Variety can be found at every turn. You're not restricted to just a few choices in people, in clubs, in classes.
Sometimes people get one-track minded when they're thinking about college, or they're thinking about, you know, what they want to major in or what they want to do. And when you go to something like this, you get presented with a lot of other ideas and a lot of other options that you might not have considered.
Through our Honors Colloquium, we are reminded that what makes a university great is the highest quality faculty and outstanding students.
as long as a fine quality diamond.
Last year, Dodge made a very dramatic announcement. In a very dramatic way. We announced that every truck we build, every full-size pickup, van, wagon, and ram charger, comes with our 5-year or 50,000-mile protection plan. And back then, we challenged Ford and Chevy to match that coverage. But you know what? Ford and Chevy still fall short. Dodge, still the best-backed trucks in America. And that's guaranteed.
No matter how hard you work, Right Guard can help keep you smelling good for up to 24 hours.
You work hard to be Right Guard.
This is Brush Plus from Gillette. A shaving concentrate and brush in one. A brush to lift whiskers, a concentrate to soften them. A shave that is
superior.
Brush Plus for a superior shave.
Soldier, we know you. Courageous and brave, the country you honored, the flag that you wave. Soldier, thank you. On Veterans Day, you're the pride of America.
From the people at Coors to America's veterans.
You're the pride of today.
Now let's take a look at the Delta halftime stats.
And you can see that Texas is very much in control on the first downs and also on total yardage. Their passing has been without fault and the time of possession. But with Tolliver in the game, moving Tech as he did, the 78 yards to the touchdown, Tech is back in the game if they stop Texas on the first possession.
And that's today's halftime statistics brought to you by Delta Airlines.
Who has over 1,500 flights a day to over 100 cities? Delta gets you there.
Riding on Texas sunshine, bringing you a welcome smile. From the Gulf Coast shores to the high Texas plains, the full Atlantic smile. Our service is above and beyond the rest. We travel Texas far and wide. We're central. Loaded with pride.
Did you see this story about Social Security?
I'm not worried.
And that Medicare business, that doesn't worry you?
Nope.
The cost of living doesn't worry you either, I'll bet. Hey, let me ask you something. How come I'm worried and you're not?
I have a Jefferson Standard agent. Let him worry.
Jefferson Standard. Our business is your future.
I used to do my own worry. Now, I'm too busy.
I'm Priscilla Presley for Gordon's Jewelers, and I know the looks a man likes in his jewelry. Men who know just where they're going choose sleekly styled rings with impressive diamonds. On the other hand, professional men like all the options Gordon's offers in rings with genuine stones. And sporty guys, they really like gold nugget rings. Gordon's Diamond and Genuine Stone ring collection has a look for every man. Wouldn't a man you know love to have one? Gordon's Jewelers, where love is in the air.
Hey, it ain't easy to do road tricks first time around. Same goes for smokeless tobacco. But here's one that's easier to use. Skoal Long Cut. Now, it's not chewing tobacco. Long Cut means it packs easy. Stays put between your cheek and gum. So Skoal Long Cut makes it easy to enjoy tobacco without lighting up.
You can get it in mint or original wintergreen. Easy to use, great taste. That's Skoal Long Cut.
It's a lot easier than this.
Today's Southwest Conference game is being brought to you by Coors. By Toyota. By the Jefferson Pilot Company. And by Delta Airlines. By Dodge. And by Curtis Mathis.
Replay of the critical plays that went against Tech in the first half. You can see Hayes, the ball is thrown by Stafford. And watch Hayes' feet. He's at the sideline. He's caught the ball and he's definitely out of bounds. However, the officials ruled it a completed pass that kept the drive alive, and then Stafford scored. A little bit later, Stafford drops back again. Carter thinks he can make the interception. He comes up, jumps for the ball, and the ball bounces through his hands. Gay makes the reception and goes 69 yards for a touchdown. Those two plays are the difference in the score at this point in time.
So Coach Brett Akers and his Texas Longhorns take a two-touchdown lead into the second half, but they're going to have to take it out against this guy, Billy Joe Tolliver, who thinks he can guide the Texas Tech Red Raiders right back into this ball game. And I don't think that there's any doubt in his mind that two touchdowns are not too much to make up. Coach, I like this kid.
He's very impressive, and the confidence that he exudes is what's amazing to me, because he hasn't had a lot of experience, but he looks as though he's just as solid in there as you can possibly be.
He walks into that huddle, and if somebody hasn't executed their assignment properly, he lets them know about it. He kicks them right you know where, or at least pats them where you know where. Okay.
Well, as you said a little bit earlier of Bobby Lane.
Oh, boy. Now let's watch as Texas Tech takes over on this kickoff here, and as they bring their offense on for the first time, let's see just what they can do. And I'm sure that Fred Akers has told his defensive unit, you got to stop these guys and take the starch out of them right on their first possession. And Henderson takes the kickoff for the return and is almost knocked down by one of his own teammates just shy of the 20-yard line. It was Beckelman downfield who made the tackle, and Billy Joe Tolliver, the freshman from Boyd, Texas, who was redshirted last year, comes on. He scored the touchdown on a one-yard plunge.
And you can see how much in charge he is as he enters the huddle to call the play.
Cole and Ferris are the halfbacks. Garnett is the fullback as they come out of the wishbone. They split Walker wide to the left side and put a man in motion. That's Ferris. Tolliver, they slant to the right with Garnett carrying, and that's pretty good yardage on that first down. Boy, you love to get eight on the first down. And Gerard Senegal, the strong safety, comes up to make the tackle.
And you can see Allert, the linebacker. There's a good block on him. He's not able to fight off the block. Garnett, the fullback, I think they were surprised that he gave the ball to the fullback that time. He picked up 9 yards on the play.
You're looking at an All-America right there, Ty Allert. Second down, we'll call it one. It's actually about a yard and a half. And it's a struggle by Cole to get the first down, and I'm not sure he did. Ansel Cole from Jay High School in San Antonio, brought down by Brian Espinoza, number 94, the junior from Whittier, California. Let's see where they mark the ball. It is lined up and still a yard short. Third down, one. Less than one, actually.
And a very key play, obviously, for Tech. They must keep possession here.
Tolliver probably wants to throw on this down.
Wouldn't be a bad idea.
Third down, one. Boy, that would kind of shake up that defense if he could complete one here. Third down. They go for the first down on the ground, and a fumble, and Billy Joe falls on the ball. It'll be a fourth down.
And that was a very unfortunate miscue again. Somehow Tech has had that happen to them far too consistently, and that's the story of why they have had trouble being ahead on the scoreboard.
It'll bring on the kicking unit. So Tolliver in the first series got within inches of a first down. Back to do the punting is Robert Grimes. 38-3 average today. He's kicking into the wind. Sends it downfield, and Eric Metcalf back for the reception. Takes it at his own 37. Metcalf gets to the 47-yard line before he is brought down. A 37-yard kick and an 8-yard return, and Mitchell made the tackle. The Southwest Conference Cross Country Championship will be held Monday, November 4th in Georgetown, hosted by the University of Texas. The defending national men's champion, Arkansas, will be shooting for its 12th straight conference title, and the defending District 6 women's champion, the Houston Cougars, will try to remain the only team to ever win the Women's Conference Championship. You're all invited to come out. First down, Texas. Brett Stafford, Charles Hunter. The defense reacts. And after maybe 2 yards, it is Larry Mathis, number 96, the defensive left end, and Roland Mitchell, 25, the left quarterback, who stopped the play for Tech. Second and 8 coming.
Texas had two wide receivers out, split away, but Peck did not widen. They were not concerned about the possible pass on the play.
Brad Hastings is limping off the field now for Tech, and Doug McKinney, number 57, comes in to replace him at middle linebacker.
He can't quite do that. He's too good a player.
And how? Stafford, tailback, Hunter at the 46. Tim Crawford, 92, the tackler after a gain of four.
Crawford is the defensive end for Tech. We see the Stafford handoff. It was a counter play. Crawford simply fights off the blocker, moves back in, makes the tackle. Excellent defensive play.
Third down, four. Timmy Crawford out of Houston, Texas. Wide outs to each side. Six out of eight third down conversions today for Texas. Here comes the blitz. And Stafford eludes the trap. And he is short of a first down, it would appear, as Mike Kinsey, 83, the strong linebacker, makes the tackle.
Well, when you got the blitz on that way and your quarterback avoids the blitz and starts to run, very unusual that he didn't make a big gain.
Now the ball is spotted. He didn't get as much as I gave him credit for. The ball is at the 46. Fourth down coming up. Thurman goes back. Number 81, the little guy. And Talchik is in. I believe that's his first punt today. This will be. 81 yards his longest, 43-6. His average, one of the outstanding kickers in the country. He is going to try to get that ball inside the 1 yard line or 2 yard line. It is a 43-yard kick, and it's down by Texas, and it will be down on the 2 yard line.
Excellent coverage by the Texas kicking team.
So we have a timeout here with 11 minutes to go in the third quarter. Texas leads Texas Tech 21-7. We'll be right back.
Soldier, we know you, courageous and brave. The country you honored, the flag that you wave. Soldier, thank you. On Veterans Day, you're the pride. America.
From the people at Coors to America's veterans.
You're the pride of today.
Everybody who builds trucks likes to talk tough, but only one talks tough and proves it. Dodge. Dodge stands behind every one of these truck parts for 5 years or 50,000 miles. Now, how many parts does Chevy and Ford back for the same amount of time? Sure, the others talk tough. Dodge proves it. Dodge. Still America's best backed trucks. That's guaranteed.
Tech has the ball on the 2 yard line. Billy Joe, is he going to throw from the end zone?
I hope so.
Boy, he probably wants to, but they go to the run and they do the pitch, and Ferris gets a little breathing room out to about the 7 yard line, and Richard Peavy, the free safety from Houston, knocks him out.
That kind of ball handling is a little more dangerous in that field position than throwing the ball would be.
I'll take the pass. I'll bet you that he tried to talk the coaching staff into throwing on first down. This guy is exciting. Second down and five. Tyrone Thurman splits out wide to the right side for Tech. They're into the wishbone. Stay to the run, go to the fullback. That's McGowan, and McGowan is out across the 10 to about the 11. And just a little bit short of a first down, it would appear. Gained a four on that play.
And on the previous possession, they came into this third down short yardage and failed to make it. It's a must for them this time in the field position that they have.
Third down, less than a yard to go. Brett Hager, number 60, the middle linebacker on the last out. Jerry Moore saw his offense breathe some new life into this ball game for Tech. They're down by 14 points with 10:23 to go in the third quarter. Third down. That's the first down with plenty to spare with James McGowan, the fine short yardage runner. Stopped by Britt Hager again, the middle linebacker.
Take a look at the play again, because it was such a key play. You see number 66, Keith, and he does a marvelous job of picking off Adams. That opens up the hole, and it was a relatively easy first down on third down short for Tech.
By the way, McGowan's the leading rusher for Tech today with 23 yards. Here's Billy Joe to throw. And he comes deep down the sideline. It is incomplete, intended for Bouvier Dale, coming out of the backfield. Covered by Richard Peavy, the free safety. James Lott was also back there. Billy Joe gives those receivers a chance to run into the ball. Double covered or not.
Well-arched pass as we see Tolliver dropping back, a little bit of a roll on it. Hangs it way up there, but Texas has got double coverage. They were looking for pass, and they do a beautiful job knocking the ball away. Also, Dale had no chance.
Also getting Dale out of bounds.
That's right.
Second down and 10 on the 14-yard line. Texas Tech down by 14 points. Dale in motion. Here comes the blitz. And the handoff doesn't work, mainly because Chris Dulabin, number 39, was coming on the blitz, and they get nothing out of that one with McGowan carrying. In fact, lost some yardage.
Hard to make the draw go against the blitz. Sometimes they will penetrate deeply enough that the ball carrier has the bend going by him as they are blitzing. But that time, Texas was under great control.
Texas bringing James Lott and four other deep backs, and Billy Joe wants to call a timeout. He looked at that defense, something looked a little strange to him. Texas going into a prevent defense, if you will, and Billy Joe goes to the sideline to talk to his coaching staff. 9:14 to go in the third quarter. Texas leads Texas Tech 21-7. We'll return to Austin after this.
Fly Delta to Europe.
To London. It's the only place to holiday.
And Delta gets you there.
Quite.
Frankfurt and Germany is the only place to have a good time. But Delta gets you there.
Come to Paris. Need I say more? And Delta gets you there, too.
London, Frankfurt, or Paris. The choice is yours.
More than telephone service, the Southwestern Bell Network is the messenger of the information age.
There are more than 1,000 7-Eleven stores in our automatic teller system, and we needed a digital network to efficiently handle transactions. We went with Southwestern Bell Telephone. Now we have a system we can all bank on.
To put information into motion, call Southwestern Bell Telephone. We're online with the future.
Remember to stay tuned for the end of the game when Bud and I will be picking the Dodge player of the game. That'll be coming up near the end of today's game. Third down, 12. Dale in motion to the right side for Tech. Tolliver cranks it up, lets it go. Dale is out there, dives for the ball. Did he come up with it? He did. First down for Texas Tech. Chris Dulabin over there covering the back, coming out of the backfield, but Billy Joe made it work for 21 yards.
Excellent throw on the play as we watch the defensive secondary of Texas give it their drop. They're all back. They're thinking pass. They've got everyone covered relatively well. The receiver, when the ball is thrown that well, can always keep his body between the defender and the ball. And they did make the completion a key play.
From the 33, Tech goes to the run. Nothing there with James McGowan being belted right at the line of scrimmage. So it'll be second down for Tech, 10 yards to go.
And pass coming up.
It is 21-7 Texas, 8 minutes, 36 seconds left to play in the third quarter on an overcast and rather chilly day in Austin. The temperature in the middle 50s. So Billy Joe Tolliver calls it on second down and 10. He sends Ferris in motion to the left side. And the blitz coming, he throws, that one is incomplete. He had to dump that ball and get rid of it in a hurry as Wayne Walker was the man in the pattern, but he had double coverage from Tilden and Peavy. So Billy Joe does recognize the defenses, it would appear, Coach.
Also had poise enough to get rid of the ball when if he had held it just one more count, the blitz would have been very successful. Good defensive play by Texas, though, covering the receivers as well as they did with as many men as they did have committed to the blitz.
Thurman comes in, Perkins goes out. Thurman bringing the play in. The 5'2", 128-pound wide receiver splitting to the right side. And Walker to the left side on third down. Here comes the blitz again. The pass deflected and knocked down. It'll be fourth down coming up. This time it was Ty Allard. who was coming and coming hard. So it is fourth down. The punting unit will come on, and a good defensive effort by the University of Texas.
Those two first downs were very important, however. Much easier to be kicking from where Texas is than where Tech is than from your own end zone.
Robert Grimes back to do the punting. Texas going for the block, missing it. And Eric Metcalf will have to let the ball roll. Good kick. Ball out of bounds somewhere on the 22-yard line. A 44-yard kick. And it'll be Texas ball on the 22. Texas leading it 21-7. Next Saturday, there's more explosive action on the Raycom Sports Network. These same Texas Longhorns will travel to the Astrodome in Houston to take on Coach Bill Yeoman's defending Southwest Conference co-champion Houston Cougars. That's Texas and Houston next Saturday at 12 noon on these Raycom Southwest Conference stations.
And this is the critical defensive series for Tech. If they can stop Texas, keep them from making a first down, they'll have good field position, and Tolliver is gaining confidence with each possession of the ball.
So Texas with Brett Stafford, who is quarterback all the way today, has a wide out to each side. Stafford handing off to his fullback. Ooh, big yardage by Jerome Johnson as he saw enough daylight to get out to the 27-yard line before King Simmons, the free safety, could bring him down. A 6-yard pickup on a first down call.
We take a look at Chester, the guard there, number 72, and you can see him pulling out and then hooking the defensive end and knocking him to the inside, keeping his feet, driving him back, and that makes it very easy for Johnson to pick up nice yardage on the play. Beautiful blocking.
Second down, 4 on the 27 of the Longhorns. Chilton over the ball. Stafford on a straight drop, throws over the middle for Gay, and it's incomplete. Everett Gay leaping to try to pull that ball down at the 46-yard line, and King Simmons had the coverage on the play. Remember, it was Gay who cut the 69-yard tip pass for a touchdown in the first half.
This is great defensive secondary play as we watch Stafford drop back. Good protection by the Texas line. He's not hurried. He delivers the ball, and it's got a good arc on it. But you can see how rapidly the Tech defenders move over. Simmons knocking the ball away.
Third down, 4 for Texas. Stafford, long count, could be checking off. Pitch the tailback, Hunter. And Hunter is stopped at the 32, and it will be very close. And he may have the first down as Roland Mitchell, number 25, the left cornerback, a junior out of Bay City, makes the tackle. It is a first down for Texas.
Reasonably good backing and very determined running by Hunter.
Danny Akers taking the instruction from his father. Here comes the sign for the play. William Harris is coming to tight end. Tim McCray has gone out. Harris had an injured hand earlier in the game on a diving catch that he made near the near sideline. He comes split to the right side. And Russell Hayes is out wide to the right. The fullback, Johnson, and Jerome to the 39. Larry Mathis, 96, makes the stop. They'll put that ball in the 38 in place of the 39.
The Texas offensive line is beginning to handle the line and linebackers of Texas.
After a gain of 6, it'll be second down, 4 for the Longhorns. Texas Tech is 3-4-0. They won their first 3 games of the year against New Mexico, Tulsa, and North Texas. Then have lost to Baylor, Texas A&M, Arkansas, and the heartbreaker 2 weeks ago to Rice. Last week they were idle. Second down. The running play with Hunter does not work. James Johnson, the weak side linebacker, the junior from Lubbock High. There he is, number 40, old dynamite himself. Third down, coming up.
And we take a look at the play again, and you can see the defensive linemen are tougher than the Texas offensive linemen. They're able to move in, stop the play, and no gain when it appeared that Texas was beginning to move the ball. Kinsey making the key tackle.
Third down. Third and 4, 7 out of 10 for Texas on third down conversion. Stafford stumbling a little bit. He turns the run into a first down with plenty to spare. He's into Tech territory. A flag goes down as he hits the 38-yard line of Texas Tech, and we'll see what the flag will mean. Clipping, Texas.
Roland Mitchell, number 25, on the tackle.
94 on White, the defensive tackle, Davis, and you can see how easily we let him come through, and he gets so much penetration, it's simple for Stafford, simply while he was blinded, to roll out, move downfield, pick up the first down on the play in a sizable gain, but it is nullified to a degree by the clipping penalty. However, he had made enough yardage that is a first down on the play.
They got enough by 1 yard. The penalty, the 15-yarder mark from the point of the foul. And it brought the ball back to the 43. And that was a yard to spare. Stafford quickly to the sideline, back into the huddle and out of the huddle. And Hayes goes wide to the left side and Everett Gay to the right side for the Longhorns. 21-7, Texas, third quarter, 5:10 to go. And Stafford throwing on the run. Hayes, a diving catch. 11 yards and a first down. The coverage by Roland Mitchell, but that's kind of a tough pass to cover against.
No way. It was a sprint out pass off of sort of a bootleg fake as we take a look at it again. See Hayes, pardon me, Stafford rolling to the outside. Hayes is well covered, but when you're coming back to the ball and it's that well thrown, you have your body between the defender and the ball and he cannot get to it.
So Russell Hayes from San Antonio is a senior. First down, Texas, 47-yard line of the Red Raiders. Stafford back to the run. That means the tailback, Hunter. And Hunter gets good blocking from the right side of the line following John Stewart. And King Simmons makes the hit down around the 37-yard line as he gets 8 on that one.
And Texas is doing a good job of mixing the pass and run. And you can see the lineman from Tech thinking pass, penetrating, and that gets them where they cannot move in on an angle of pursuit. Hunter finds a little daylight, and there's no pursuit there. He picks up very close to the first down on the play.
Second and short, 2 yards, we'll call it. Got a wide out to the left, that's Gaze. Put to the right side is Russell Hayes. Hunter breaking a tackle and getting the first down. Down to the 34 where Larry Mathis, 96, who's been very busy today. He's out of Adamson High School in Dallas, makes the stop. They mark the ball at the 35 in place of the 34. It is still a first down. Red Acres has got to like the way now that the offense has taken control in this drive. They're using the clock and they're marching down the field and they've got a 2-touchdown lead and they've got to feel pretty comfortable right now.
And they're balancing their pass and run very well. Stafford is checking signals quite often at the line of scrimmage.
Stafford, play action, rolling right and throwing, and it is Johnson out of the backfield, the fullback, and he has dumped it to 30.
Stafford does a good job of throwing on the run and on the move most of the time when he has thrown the ball, but he's thrown with extreme accuracy.
Gain of 6, second down 4 coming up. Carl Carter gets the last tackle, and the clock shows 3 minutes coming up with Texas leading 21-7.
Line of scrimmage is the 29.
Texas Tech won two ball games, as we alluded to earlier here. One before they remember the conference, and then one in 1967 on this turf. Stafford in trouble throwing and getting it to his fullback. Flag on the play, however. Jerome Johnson has rolled out of bounds at about the 22-yard line. King Simmons making the hit, and we've got a clipping penalty against Texas.
And Stafford, again, did a marvelous job of avoiding a blitz. He got rid of the ball and completed the pass. The clipping penalty holder is going to nullify it.
So this foul took place in the 35-yard line. And here comes the march. 15 Biggins. Going out of the ball game now is Artis Jackson for Texas Tech as they make a switch on the defensive line.
Watch Stafford and the replay here, spinning out. The tackle is blocking for him, 72, and you can see the clip. That's just as bad a clip as you can possibly make. If he had not done it, of course, the passer would have been rushed. The pass was completed, but a good call on the clip.
Second down, 19. Stafford doesn't get too much. Carrying that ball to the 48-yard line, getting only about 2. Perry, defensive tackle, in there on the stop. Charles filling in. He's rotated for Scott Davis. So now Stafford looks to the sideline for help. Third down, 23.
And Texas is thinking, let's make enough yardage on this play to give Ward the field goal position, even if we do not get the first down.
They send three wide receivers to the left side. That splits the coverage. Now it's Hunter back in motion to the right side, and Stafford, he was down to 2 seconds on the clock, and he looked up there and said, wait a minute, let's don't take any more penalties here. He calls a timeout.
Three wide receivers going out, then a man in motion, and it takes a little while.
So we're down to a minute 59 to go in the third quarter. Texas still leads by 2 touchdowns.
Not so very long ago, the average four-cylinder engine looked something like this. But these days, four-cylinder engines look a little more like this. That's why we developed new Valvoline 4-Guard motor oil, specially formulated to protect today's harder-working, more complex four-cylinder engines. And it won't break down, even after 7,500 miles. Times have definitely changed. So maybe it's time to change your oil to new Valvoline 4-Guard.
What do you want to be when you grow up?
A baseball player. A movie star.
At Pilot Life, we know how important dreams are.
An astronaut.
After all, we've been insuring them for over 80 years.
A teacher.
With affordable life insurance policies that can guarantee your children's dreams.
A doctor.
Where are you going to get the money to be a doctor?
My daddy.
At Pilot Life, we believe nothing should happen to your children's dreams if something should happen to you. You see, we never forget that behind every policy is a person.
Merle Herman and Bud Wilkinson with you in Austin, Texas, where Texas leads 21-7. That was the score at halftime. We've got a minute and 59 seconds left to play in the third quarter, and Texas is looking at a third and 23. Stafford at quarterback. Here comes the blitz. Safety blitz this time. He gets that pass away for Hayes, and they pick up enough yardage, although it's not a first down, but they got what you were talking about, Bud. They put Ward in field goal range. Eric Everett had the coverage, and they get 19 on that play.
Excellent execution on third down passes by Stafford with great consistency. This is the best pass defense in the Southwest Conference, and he's burned them on third down and long yardage 4 times.
It'll be 4th and 4. And the field goal unit is on with Danny Akers to hold. Jeff Ward, all Southwest Conference kicker a year ago. He'll be going from the 36, add 10 to that, 46-yard effort, left hash mark. That'll get him a little closer, unless somebody in the offensive line moved.
You get him a first down if the offensive line didn't move.
Apparently, Gene Chilton, the center, moved. And that will cost Texas 5, and that should make it, let me see, 46. Ooh, boy, that gets Ward back there pretty deep.
I think he's got range enough if he hits it the way he would like to hit it.
Jeff Ward, he's half of the great kicking game of Texas. Of course, Telchik, one of the outstanding punters in the nation. Last year, he set a record against Tech for best average. This could be a 51-yard effort by Jeff Ward. Danny Akers holding. Looks like he's got the distance. 51-yard field goal.
All of that movement by the Tech men, the linebackers, just doesn't disturb his concentration in the slightest. He keeps his eye perfectly on the ball.
Down to a minute 45 seconds to go in the third quarter. Texas builds its lead by 3 points, 24-7. We'll be back.
In countries you've never heard of. Through towns you could never find. Toyota has the corner on performance. Now it's at your Toyota dealers. MR2 twin cam two-seater mid-engine design. Celica GTS all-new twin cam, all-new front-wheel drive. Now, on top of reliability and dependability, your Toyota dealer has the corner on performance, too. Who could ask for anything more?
No matter how hard you work, Right Guard can help keep you smelling good for up to 24 hours.
You work hard, you need Right Guard.
This is Brush Plus from Gillette. A shaving concentrate and brush in one. A brush to lift whiskers, a concentrate to soften them. A shave that is
superior.
Brush Plus for a superior shave.
Want to see the longest 4 seconds in a coach's life?
The Amateur Association is located right back on the street from the stadium.
Waiting to see if it was good.
If they hadn't completed that pass, he would not have been in range.
So Jeff Ward, a 51-yard field goal, the second longest of his career. He's had a 52-yarder, and he'll be handling the kickoff right now. Ward from Westlake High School right here in Austin, a junior.
His 12th field goal of the year.
Last year, remember, he kicked those two field goals out in Lubbock in the last minute or so. In fact, the winner came with only 3 seconds left as Texas beat Tech 13-10 in Lubbock a year ago.
Jeff Walker will kick off.
Walker and Henderson are deep. It'll go to Walker about 5 yards deep in the end zone. He's going to bring it out. Comes out to about the 17.
Have to admire his aggressiveness, but question his judgment.
Yeah, 5 yards a little deep to come back. So Billy Joe Tolliver and company come on the field. Billy Joe appeared in the last few minutes of the Rice game, almost brought Tech to a victory. In fact, the ball was dropped to the end zone after time had run out. Or Tech would have won that one. Billy Joe from his own 17. On the option, he pitches to Cole, who fumbles the football. Texas going after it. Looks like the Horns have it. And Peavy, the free safety, comes up with a recovery. Boy, that's going to be a tough one for Tech to overcome now.
Here's Texas' great field position as we look at it again. Tolliver goes down the line, fakes to the fullback. And he made the right pitch, but simply failed to handle the ball properly, muffed it, bounces around. Texas recovers, and they have the ball on the 16-yard line. I think that's the first turnover of the game.
So Texas right back on the doorsteps of Texas Tech again. A minute, 31 seconds to go in the third quarter. Blitz is on. Stafford eludes it. Throws it a run. Has it completed to his fullback, Jerome Johnson, who's out of bounds inside the 5-yard line. Scott Davis had the tackle. Bill Boy Bryant is now in the ball game for Texas. And the blitz was coming. It looked like Carl Carter was coming from the left side.
Stafford really does a marvelous job here. As you see him rolling out, one man going the wrong way, but he simply comes fast enough, quickly enough, to get the corner turned. And then, while moving forward, drills the ball downfield. Excellent reception, but a great play by Stafford.
Leonard Jones is coming out of the backfield in the blitz. And touchdown, Texas, as Darren Norris scores his third touchdown of the year. So the Longhorns, who did not score for the first 13 minutes or so of this third quarter, have now come up with a field goal and a touchdown and lead it 30-7 with 59 seconds remaining, and Ward is in there for the extra point try with Danny Akers to hold. Ward is perfect, 17 out of 17, 18 out of 18 field goal or other extra point wise this year. 59 seconds to go, 31-7 Texas.
And let's take a look at the touchdown play again. Stafford, the quarterback, spinning out, handing it off to Norris. And you can see the beautiful read that he makes as he cuts back slightly to find plenty of daylight and move it into the end zone. Take a look at it one more time from behind, and you can see him make that little bit of a weave, and I see him cut back, going against the grain, finding the daylight, moving to the touchdown.
Darren Norris from El Camino, California, who had rushed for 246 yards coming into this ballgame today, which gave him an average of 8.5 per carry. Got to be impressed with Darren Norris. 59 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Ward will handle the kickoff. Once once again, back deep, Keith Henderson and Wayne Walker for Texas Tech. Ward booms this one back into the end zone, and this time I think Walker probably had a note from the sideline after the last kickoff. If it's that deep, don't bring it back. It'll be the Raiders ball, first and 10 of their own 20. Two plays, 15 yards after the fumble recovery.
It's got to get the Tech team jobbers down just a little bit to turn it over. They played an excellent third quarter, weren't able to score, but they certainly were threatening Texas all the time, and now, of course, the score is widened to the point it will be very difficult.
Let's see if Billy Joe will throw on first down here. He's into the wishbone. First and 10 from the Tech 20. Nope, they'll stay with the run. They come back on a reverse, and Walker is at the 30. Walker at the 40. Walker should go all the way on this baby. Touchdown! Wayne Walker from Jefferson High School in Waco, Texas, got a key block from Aubrey Richburg, number 54, the left tackle, and that's all he needed. 80-yard touchdown run by Wayne Walker with world-class speed.
Great execution of the deep reverse. The play looks almost like the wishbone option, but the pitch is going to the flanker coming back from the other side.
Mallory for the extra point try, and this is just the old chip shot for him. It's good. So Texas Tech comes back to score quickly after Texas had scored following the fumble recovery, 31-14 Texas.
Watch the execution of Tolliver here as he pitches the ball almost the same way he would if it were the regular option play, and Lawrence is coming back to the opposite side, and you can see the great speed. He also got a fine block from his flanker there, and there's nobody going to catch this man once he's in the open with room to run.
So Walker with that 80-yard strike.
And we take another look at it. You can see how Texas does move with the start of the quarterback. Tolliver going in the wrong direction. And when the pitch comes, they're all moving the wrong way. There was a fine block that time by the flanker. And Lawrence is absolutely off to the races. And it is an easy score.
So Wayne Walker, longest touchdown run from scrimmage this year in the Southwest Conference.
And he's pretty happy, and just tossed the ball to the official. And wait till we get the ball again, we'll do it again.
You know, Walker had committed to come to the University of Texas and changed his mind, went to Texas Tech. He was really looking forward to this ball game today. He was one of the most sought-after high school players in Texas at Jefferson Moore in Waco. He's a happy kid right now. Scott Segrist will handle the kickoff for Texas Tech. The freshman from Garnota High School in Lubbock bangs it downfield into that wind. High, it'll be Eric Metcalf from the 5 on the return. The pursuit is there, and he gets crunched at about the 12.
Well, Texas again was looking for an onside kick, had a 9 men up within 15 yards of the ball, and left Metcalf all alone. He couldn't get much blocking for him.
First down on the 12-yard line, Tim Singley made that tackle. 40 seconds to go in the third quarter. Texas leading at 31-14. You know, this was kind of a dull quarter for about 12 minutes.
Well, Texas was getting control of the game, and then they got that fortunate fumble and the easy touchdown after the field goal where they completed a key pass to put Ward within range, but Tech is back with that beautiful executed reverse play by Lawrence.
First down on the 12. Stafford at quarterback for UT. Fumbled by Jerome Johnson. He goes after the ball himself, though, and he may have come up with it at about the 17-yard line.
And everybody that's a Tech fan is thinking, fumble or interception. Somehow we're going to get a turnover from Texas. Let's take another look at it. Stafford, who's gone all the way at quarterback, handing the ball off. The ball gets away, but it's one of those beautiful bounces. Comes right back up to Johnson.
It is a second down and 6, and we have 7 seconds to go in the third quarter. Tailback gets the call. That's Charles Hunter and Doug McKinney, the middle linebacker, there to meet him just shy of the 20. Got 3 yards on the play. And the third quarter has come to an end. It'll be about 3 yards short of a first down when we resume play in the fourth quarter. And we'll be back after these messages from your local stations on the Raycom Sports Network.
Come home to Branch Creek Estates.
We didn't think we could afford a home, much less a place like this, with carpeting, draperies, even appliances.
And plenty of room to grow. All this for about the same we used to pay for rent. The homes are set at ground level, complete with two-car garage.
And country club features, like separate recreation areas for families and adults.
You really have to see it for yourself.
Come and stay at Branch Creek Estates.
Riverbend is a unique fellowship of caring people.
From the very first day that I visited, I felt part of it.
I come away from church feeling refreshed and ready for the next week.
It's a unit that we can share and be together with.
I found when I came here, they fully accepted me. That's just the way the church has always been, and we've grown and grown, and we're still that way.
KBBO-TV, Austin.
That graphic that you're looking at right now as we start the fourth quarter has got to send Coach Fred Akers for the aspirin bottle a couple of times, Coach Wilkinson.
Well, you don't often have that happen, and when you're in control at the end of the first half, if you can just keep your poise, stop the opponent. But Texas somehow has not been able to do this, and I don't think it's a lack of conditioning because I know that Fred Akers has his team in excellent shape.
So here come the Longhorns with a third down and three as we start the fourth quarter. Power eye. Dodge keeps it himself. First down and more. And Stafford, I beg your pardon, is finally thrown out of bounds up near the midfield stripe at about the 48-yard line. So Brett Stafford, who's quarterback all the way, is rolled out of bounds by Carl Carter after a gain of 26.
This is the same play that they called to score their touchdown earlier in the game. You can see it's a power eye formation. Stafford takes to the fullback. Tech closes on the fullback. Stafford keeps the ball, and he looks like a halfback running.
You know, I mentioned Dodge a moment ago, who's not been in the ball game today, and the way Stafford has been going, and since Dodge is a senior and Stafford is a junior, I would imagine that Todd Dodge will probably spend a lot of time watching Stafford play the rest of the year. Bill Boy Bryant is now in. He's back from the injured list for Texas as a wideout. Go to the tailback. And it is Eric Metcalf, brought down by Tim Crawford, 92, the defensive left end. He got two on the play and a second and eight coming.
And Stafford has been a truly impressive football player. As we've mentioned, most of the passes that he's thrown have been on the run. He's thrown on third and long and completed the pass, having good reaction, of course, by his receivers coming back to the ball, but he's been an impressive quarterback in this game.
Bill Boy Bryant comes foot to the left side. Second down. Stafford, the deep pitch to Eric Metcalf, and Metcalf gets across midfield and takes a real punch on the 49-yard line. And the lead tackler is Leonard Jones. Metcalf picked up four. Tim Crawford again saying hello to Eric Metcalf. Eric, an outstanding high school player in Arlington, Virginia. All-Metro, Washington, D.C. Outstanding All-Metro player in Washington. Third down and four.
And once again, a key play for Tech. They must stop them here.
Third down, four coming up. Bill Boy Bryant splits out wide to the right side. A spinning, churning run by Jerome Johnson, and he has the first down at the 44-yard line. Merv Skurlark, number five, the sophomore from Monahans, Texas, on the hit, and he is a hitter.
And a great job of play calling by Texas. The other previous third down play, Stafford faked to the fullback. Found a lot of daylight himself as we look at how much yardage Texas has made. This last time, instead of faking to the fullback, he gave it to him, and he picked up the first down.
First down, the ball close to the 43-yard line. That's where we'll call it. How about that one? With Metcalf carrying James Johnson, who was coming, and Michael Johnson, 42, in there for the loss. Mosley also got involved in the action.
they were all coming, expecting run, and they got the penetration bingo and made the hit. Crawford first and then Mosley, and they were thinking fumble on the play. They didn't quite get the fumble, but they got the loss.
Second down, 13 for Texas. Billboy Bryant splits to the left side. Gay is wide to the left for Texas. Stafford makes the pitch to Metcalf, the tailback. He cannot turn the corner. Good pursuit there, but the defense, they react very well. Doug McKinney, 57, the middle linebacker, getting over there in a hurry.
Let's watch the play again, and Chester, the right guard, number 72, you can see him just at the top of your screen. What a beautiful job he does of knocking the Texas end, pardon me, the Tech end off. Then he gives the ball carrier Hunter a chance to turn the corner, but he didn't quite get around. He picked up a good gain on the play, thanks though to Chester's good block.
After the 6-yard pickup, it is still 3rd down, 7. Here comes the blitz. Stafford rolling left and throwing on the run. It is caught by Tim McCray, the tight end. An excellent job, but a flag was thrown on the play back near midfield, and that's probably a holding call. Or is it against Texas Tech for roughing? 18 yards picked up on the play. Apparently the foul is going to be against Tech.
Once again, it's marvelous execution by Stafford as we see him drop back, then to suddenly spin, get outside of the Tech defense, throw the ball down the field, going to his left. And again, it's a beautiful reception by McCray. You could see how he kept his body between the defender and the ball.
Yep, roughing the passer is the call. Stafford, 9 out of 10 passing today, 177 yards, 1 touchdown, no interception.
Let's take a look at Billboy Bryant, the wide receiver here. You can see him start downfield, little fake to the outside, then breaks it again to the outside, and he's been hurt all season. As you can see him here, he once again is limping and doesn't look like he's got his full speed.
First down, Texas. Stafford gives off to his fullback, and that is Darren Norris. Mike Kinsey, 83, the strong linebacker. Look at him right in the face at the 23-yard line. 11 minutes and 5 seconds to go in the ball game. Fred Akers and his Longhorns leading by a score of 31-14.
And comfortably within field goal range.
Always got Mr. Ward. For Jerry Moore, a nightmare first half, one very questionable call, another tip pass and a 69-yard touchdown resulting from it. And a tough day for Tech. Second down, 10. Norris straight ahead inside the 20 to the 19. And Chilton once again blocking straight ahead. Artis Jackson, 69. The Tank at 285, 6'5", makes the tackle. Gain of 4 on the play, however. Ward doing a little warm-up on the sideline.
Don't know if he needs it. He sure executes well.
Had a 51-yard field goal, the second longest of his career in the third quarter. Stafford, as you see, has also carried the ball for 59 yards. Texas has done a much better job holding onto that football today. You know, they fumbled 21 times and lost 11 this year. Stafford loops it up there with a blitz on, incomplete, intended for Russell Hayes in the end zone. The coverage by Charles Jackson, the free safety, number 45.
And the blitz was on. He read the blitz beautifully, but Jackson did a good job of covering the hot receiver.
So this is Mr. Ward again. Always anticipating. He's probably standing over and saying, don't you guys score? We got a 31-14 lead. Give me a chance to kick another one. This will be a 37-yard effort right up the middle with Danny Akers holding. Ward, plenty of foot into that one, even into the wind. A 37-yard field goal is good. But Texas puts 3 more on the board. And with 9:51 left to play in the game, it's Texas 34, Texas Tech 14, and we'll return after this.
Unmistakably hot, unmistakably cool, unmistakably sharp, unmistakably smooth, unmistakably right.
What kind of person buys a Curtis Mathis stereo?
The technology is unbelievable.
Well, a person who appreciates the quality and engineering of top-of-the-line audio systems.
I'll pay by check. Every month.
Or a person who wants easy monthly payments on the only stereo with a 4-year warranty.
We don't want to buy it.
We want to rent it.
Or someone who doesn't want to rent just any old stereo, but a Curtis Mathis. Curtis Mathis stereo components.
You won't believe your ears.
Texas 34, Texas Tech 14. 74,000 or so here today. Had some no-shows because of the rain. It really rained very hard here all day yesterday, all throughout the night. And we've had a light mist in the first half. But it has not affected Brett Stafford, number 10, the Texas quarterback, who's had an outstanding afternoon.
He's got great movement after he snapped the ball. He changes direction well and gets himself open to throw the ball, but he's also an excellent ball carrier.
Kelly Robinson has identified the Texas Tech players for us today. Bobby Little for Texas. Thank you, gentlemen. It's going to be a little short, and the ball is grabbed around the 11-yard line. Bringing it back is Gerald Bean, and Bean gets up near the 29. Now let's check the scoreboard and see what else is happening today.
Maryland winning, and Penn State getting a problem for Boston College, and Syracuse as large as their lead. And Minnesota coming back against Michigan State, Georgia killing Tulane. Oklahoma State beating Colorado, and Tech having a tougher time with Duke than they expected.
First down, Billy Joe Tolliver, quarterback for Texas Tech. He drops back to throw. A little play action. Here comes the blitz, and Dulavin goes after him, and he gets him down. They were also coming from the other side. Loss of 6 yards on the play. Let's check more scores now while we have an opportunity with the North Carolina State leading South Carolina, third quarter.
Michigan and Illinois in the second quarter. Indiana beating Wisconsin, and that's somewhat of an upset. Florida against Auburn, and that would be an upset. Mississippi State and Alabama tied, but it's only the first quarter. And LSU holding their lead against Mississippi.
Second down, 16 for Texas Tech. Dale in motion to the right. Tolliver looks, and he's got Ferris wide open coming out of the backfield. Irvin Ferris at the 32-yard line. So he got back the yards they lost, plus two more. Jackson on the tackle. And it'll be a gain of 9 on the play. More scores now. Kansas leading Oklahoma in the first quarter.
And Nebraska is expected against Kansas State. Houston TCU 0-0. Arkansas and Rice, same score, but first quarter also.
Third down, 7, a long 7. That's Ferris in motion. Going to the top of your screen, here comes the rush. And Billy Joe Tolliver is going to have to run the football, and he gets back to the line of scrimmage, and that's about all. So Tolliver is brought down by Mike Jackson, who's now the defensive line for Texas, number 88.
And excellent defensive series by Texas. They put great pressure on Tolliver. He simply did not have an opportunity to let the receivers get downfield, run their patterns, and then have time to get the ball to them.
So Robert Grimes comes in to handle the punting. Eric Metcalf deep. Oh, they almost blocked it. Flag goes down. They get a penalty on roughing the kicker as Metcalf on the return. And Metcalf sees some daylight, cuts it back to the middle and right into the arms of Bronner, who was up there. Mitchell, rather.
And roughing the kicker going to be called. And that, of course, will give Texas Tech a first down.
Pawalik, rather, I think is going to get that call on roughing the kicker. Ty Allard.
And we had another flag dropped down the field after the kicker had been rushed.
Billy Joe Tolliver in the offense is back on the field now. Ty Allard, one of the co-captains of Texas, going in to see if he can't get the word on what's happening here. We have 7 minutes, 47 seconds left to go in the game. Texas is leading Texas Tech 34-14. You'll see Texas again next week at Houston in the Astrodome against the Houston Cougars. And Bud and I will be there to report it for you at noon on Raycom Sports.
Oklahoma 0.
Boy, this is... I thought that meeting in the United Nations ended last week.
I thought so, too. Long discussion here. Just a question of the timing of when the penalties occurred, and that's an official decision that is official judgment, and so we just have to wait for it.
Billy Joe Tolliver and Carl Carter trying to help out the call here. Well, here comes the call. Let me figure that one out, will you?
I don't know why they...
Roughing the kicker, so apparently they... Well, I guess they wouldn't have gotten the first down.
Well, if the penalty had been long enough, it would have been a first down, and I think it simply was not a very good decision by accepting the penalty. Let's take a look at it, and you can see the roughing of the kicker.
Okay, that was running into the kicker and not roughing, apparently. I believe. Let's see. Running into the kicker? Yes.
But if you hit the kicker, that's the penalty, and there's no question about it. And then again, we see right in the middle of the screen here, and you can see the clip. Bingo, right there on 96, and Metcalf gets it turned upfield. That Texas gets the ball. I think that they could have gotten the first down, Texas Tech, by accepting the roughing of the kicker penalty.
Shannon Kelly is now the quarterback for the University of Texas as he runs his first play, and it is stopped by Tim Crawford. Peter Pope getting the call. We haven't seen much of Peter Pope this year. The difference in what we did the replay, running to the kicker is not a, running into the kicker is not a major penalty. Roughing the kicker is. Running into the kicker is 5 yards, and so they wouldn't have had the first down, as we more or less alluded to.
That's
anyway.
Correct.
Running play with Nelson, the wide receiver, getting the call. Also a running back, and Mike Kinsey stopped the play. Fred Aker starting to use a lot of running backs now. Second down coming up, 7 yards to go for Texas. We had a flag in the last play and a clipping call against Texas.
Doesn't hurt them very much to get all of these penalties at score as it is and this late in the game.
Fred Aker's using a lot of people now. That penalty will take the ball back to the 7 yard line, 7 minutes, 5 seconds remaining in the ball game. Anthony Byerly is now in. We haven't seen much of him this year either. Shannon Kelly, a blue chipper, has not played until right now. Has the strongest arms of all the Texas quarterbacks. He's 6'2", 172 pounds from Memorial High School in Houston. And he is now the quarterback for Texas. Second down, 16. Peter Pope, no place to go. It was Tim Crawford, 92, who's been very busy today for Texas Tech, the defensive left end.
The people have been working on him, but they have not been able to block him. As you said, he's been on almost all the tackles and plays that come his way.
When Mary Lou Retton goes to parties, her date is Shannon Kelly, who's now the quarterback for Texas. Third down, 14. The fullback gets the call, and they get across the 10, but that's all. Brad Hastings sticks his nose in there to knock Peter Pope off his feet. So it's fourth down and still about 12 for Texas. 5 minutes, 53 seconds left of the ball game. The Longhorns of Texas lead the Red Raiders of Texas Tech 34-14. At halftime, Tech trailed 21-7. Tyrone Thurman goes back deep to get ready to accept. Is this the second punt of the day for Talchik? It is.
That's correct. He's averaging 43.6 yards per kick.
Talchik barefoots it. High into the air and downfield. The ball is going to be fielded by Thurman at the 45. And Thurman is knocked off his feet at the 45. Of Texas, a 43-yard kick and a 9-yard return by Thurman. And we'll come back to Memorial Stadium in just a moment.
You know, when I started dipping Kodiak, made my friend here real happy because it's his brand. Now it's my brand, too. It's good and moist with a special cut that packs right. And it's got a big, fresh wintergreen flavor. But don't take my word for it. Just ask my friend here. He really got away with words, don't he?
Texas. 71,000 miles of highway and over 3,200 towns and cities, and no one covers it like Central Freight Lines. Truckloads, packages, big business and small, Central's been serving Texas reliably for over 60 years. Now in big cities like Dallas and Houston, you've come to expect that kind of service. And in a town the size of Gun Barrel City, well, you can expect it too. Central Freight Line. We're loaded with pride.
Red Raiders have the ball on the Texas 45-yard line. Good field position for Billy Joe Tolliver at quarterback. They go into the wishbone, and Thurman, check that, Walker splits out wide to the right side. Walker scored on an 80-yard touchdown run on a reverse. Here is Tolliver looking for him. Tolliver lets it go, arching it high for Walker, and it is tipped away before he can get his hand on the ball by Stephen Braggs, the left quarterback.
Ball a little bit underthrown. Lawrence going down the field. He's got this beautiful speed. Look at when he turns it on. The Texas people are after him, but the ball is underthrown. He's got to wait for it. That gives the Texas defender a chance to see the ball, reach up, knock it away.
Now it's second down and 10 on the 45-yard line. This time, Lemuel Stinson is split to the right side for Texas Tech as he has come into the ball game. Bean in motion, now comes back in the wing spot as Tolliver looks and throws, and it's incomplete. Texas, want to make sure that wasn't, they were looking maybe lateral, but it wasn't, as Stinson was the intended receiver on the screen right.
Texas was playing screen all the way as we take a look at the receiver going downfield and then coming back. But the Texas defender, Stinson, is right there with him all of the way. Man-for-man pass defense, beautifully executed.
Lemuel Stinson is the young man who was in the end zone apparently to catch a winning touchdown pass against Rice. Had it bounce off his chest, and you talk about a kid that was heartbroken. The teammates rallied around him as Tolliver now drops to throw, and Tolliver under a rush throws it incomplete. Intended for Gerald Bean coming out of the backfield as Senegal had the coverage, the strong safety. Now that Texas defensive unit is really putting some heat on Billy Joe Tolliver.
Doing a good job of rushing, but also an excellent job of coverage in the secondary by the safety men, cornerbacks, and the linebackers.
Fourth down coming up. Walker comes in.
I'm glad to see him going for it.
Yes, sir. Fourth down, 10 yards to go on the 44-yard line of Texas. 5 minutes, 2 seconds remaining in the ball game. Bruce Perkins splits wide to the left side. Coming to the right side is Wayne Walker. Bean in motion. Tolliver on a drop. Here comes the blitz. He tries to get out of it. He's got enough room to run for a first down. And he's got it and more as Billy Joe Tolliver is out of bounds on the 25-yard line of the University of Texas. Run out of bounds by Gerald Senegal, the strong safety. A 20-yard run by Tolliver.
This is a beautiful execution by this young quarterback. You see him dropping back, and Texas is blitzing. You can see them all come. I didn't know he had this much speed. But he turns the corner. They lost leverage on him. Then he turns it upfield, gets a block from his flanker, picks up the extra yardage, and gains 20 yards on the play.
The ball has been officially marked on the 26-yard line now as Tolliver, who gained 924 yards as a senior last year running the football, shows that he can still carry. McGowan, Texas defense took a look at that and said, a little bit of a delay or a draw, and McGowan got nothing but maybe a yard loss. Blake Brawner, 85, the senior from Richardson, made the tackle for Texas. Second and 11 coming.
Take a look at the Texas defensive secondary this time, see whether they're blitzing, whether it's zone or whether it's man-to-man. It's been blitz or man-to-man most of the time.
Tolliver, second down 11. A lot of movement on that line. Flags go down all over the place. That almost is picked off by the University of Texas. Wayne Walker was the intended receiver and the cover man for the University of Texas was Fulbright. who's now in the defensive secondary. Let's see what the flags are about.
It was illegal procedure, I believe, on the part of Tech.
Dead ball, false start. Second down is the call. Second down and almost 16. Two wingmen, two wideouts, in motion is Dale. Tolliver under a rush again, gets hit and still gets the ball away, and it's incomplete. What a recovery by Billy Joe Tolliver, and Dale, who was split to the right, cut back across the field. He was covered by Fulbright and also by Jeffries, and somehow Tolliver got that ball away.
This is excellent execution. See Tolliver dropping back, and here comes the Texas blitz. He pulls the ball down, moves two steps to his left, throws the ball downfield against double coverage, and had the ball pretty well on target. Incomplete pass, good coverage, but a great move by Tolliver.
And that one, now, as we saw on the replay, was catchable. Wideouts, four. Hole in motion, go to the run, fumble again, and Texas recovery. Bronner fell on the ball. So once again, Texas Tech coughs the ball up on a fumble. And with 3 minutes and 44 seconds left of the game, Texas leads it by 34 to 14.
When you want cash discounts on great gasolines, who's got it?
Gulf's got it!
Who's got low self-serve prices?
Gulf's got it.
And when you want credit card convenience, who's got it?
Gulf got it.
Cash discounts plus low self-serve prices for extra savings and credit card convenience. Who's got it all?
Gulf's got it. Gulf's got it all.
Delta professionals always make you feel like you're on top of the world. Delta gets you there.
It's Texas Tech fumbling the ball away today. Texas, on the other hand, has fumbled once and recovered that fumble. Texas, going into the game today, had fumbled 21 times and lost 11 of those. Kelly, the quarterback, throwing on the run, and a completion at the 45-yard line. Johnson, the wideout, Gabriel Johnson, brought down by Charles Jackson, the free safety.
Number 31. Kelly looks like he's a man with a great future. Throwing out, throwing on a run, hitting Johnson perfectly, right in the numbers.
First down, 45-yard line of Texas, 3 minutes, 30 seconds left in the game. Gabriel Johnson splits out wide to the left side. Shannon Kelly, the sophomore redshirt from Houston, now guiding the Texas offense, goes to the fullback. Straight ahead on the dive is Darren Norris. And they get out to the 49-yard line with that play. Tackle made by Ellis. Anthony Byerly in place of Darren Norris. 24, place 34.
Last week against SMU, Texas turned the ball over six times. This afternoon, no turnovers.
Wide to the left side comes Gabriel Johnson on a second down and six. This one, Shannon Kelly. James Mosley, the freshman defensive end, covered him in a hurry. They lose a yard.
Couldn't tell whether he was trying to run the option play or whether he just kind of got a bad start in the backfield.
Third down, seven.
In the second quarter, Ohio State, Iowa, zero.
Third down coming up for Texas. Shannon Kelly now the quarterback. Kelly throwing over the middle, and a diving attempt for that one by Lucky is incomplete, and Mike Kinsey had the coverage on the play. Bud and I are watching today's game on monitors supplied by Curtis Mathis. Curtis Mathis, a little more expensive, but worth it. So the punting unit comes on for Texas. Coach Fred Akers using a lot of people now. 2 minutes, 6 seconds left of the ball game. Texas has this one wrapped up, 34-14 the score right now, and John Tulchik comes out to do the kicking. Thurman is back deep. Tyrone Thurman. Wynn catches that ball. It's fielded by the short man, and that's Leonard Jones, who's up short, taking the ball at about the 23. A 30-yard punt and no return. Exactly 2 minutes left to play, and Texas has a 20-point lead.
Soldier, we know you, courageous and brave. The country you honor, the flag that you wave. Soldier, thank you. On Veterans Day, you're the pride of America.
From the people at Coors to America's veterans.
You're the pride of today.
So this is Beverly Hills, huh? Guess I'll get used to it. A rodeo's called Rodeo. And the best hotel is Pink. I'm checking in, they're checking out. My machine is standing out. What's the matter with y'all? Ain't you ever seen a truck?
Beverly Hills Truck, Leroy has arrived. A new Dodge truck, stars are in their eyes. Beverly Hills Truck, Leroy has arrived. A new Dodge truck.
Today's Dodge player of the game is Brett Stafford of the University of Texas. Dodge will contribute $1,000 to member institutions of the Southwest Conference, and the money will be distributed according to a conference approved plan. Our Dodge player of the game, Brett Stafford of the University of Texas. Billy Joe Tolliver, the quarterback, under a rush again. Now cranks up, lets her go. Look at that ball go, will you? And it's caught. It is caught. And picking that one out of the air is Wayne Walker, who's already had a big afternoon for Texas Tech. He is down to the 15-yard line where Senegal runs him out of bounds.
Tolliver has great poise. You see him dropping back. Then he's flushed out of the pocket. He's moving to his left. Sees downfield. Receiver Lawrence wide open. And he's got enough arm, even though he was throwing from that awkward position, to drop the ball right on target. Big, big play. Great execution.
62 yards on the play. His arm is so strong on an almost a touchdown pass early. He threw off the wrong foot. He was going to throw off the wrong foot there. He does again. Wide open. Touchdown. Perkins.
He is an impressive young man.
Perkins, nobody around him. Nowhere. Touchdown for Texas Tech.
Man-for-man pass defense, and when you lose your man, he is wide open, and Perkins was on that play.
Tolliver's got one of the strongest arms I've ever seen, Coach.
Particularly when he's moving in the wrong direction. It's very hard to throw the ball when you're right-handed moving to your left and you're off balance, but he just whoop. Great, great arm.
Now the extra point try. Mallory pops it. And it's good. So with a minute 33 seconds left of the game, Texas leading it 34-21.
And let's watch Tolliver again as he drops back. He's rushed, moves forward, and beautiful poise. Puts it right on the target to Perkins, who is wide, wide open since they were man for man and somebody forgot to cover him. Let's take one more look at the poise Tolliver has as he starts forward, avoids the rush, then sees his receiver wide open and drills the ball off balance right to the proper target.
So with a minute 33 to go in the ball game, Tech fans are encouraged by this young man, Billy Joe Tolliver.
No possession is more precious than life, and no business more rewarding than improving life.
At Jefferson Pilot, we've spent over 75 years making lives better, richer, and more secure through our companies in insurance, broadcasting, and publishing. Jefferson Pilot, dedicated to life and the things that make it worth living.
On a cloudy, overcast, misty day, we now have sunshine at Memorial Stadium in Austin, Texas. And Mallory is getting all keyed up for an onside kick as they overload the left side of the field, or top side, if you will, on your screen. Texas with lots of hands, receivers, and backs up there to field this ball, and they go for it. It is still bouncing around, and Tech may have it. Nope, one more time, it got away. The officials will dig it out.
They had their shot.
They sure did. Looked like they had it at the 40, and then apparently it eluded the would-be man who recovered, and it's finally pulled out of there, and Braggs gets the recovery.
Excellent execution of the onside kick. Mallory coming across, kicking the ball on the ground. It bounces, and it took the beautiful hop for Tech. Texas receiver went up to get it, but the ball bounces loose, and now look at the number of men that try to fall on the ball. It appeared Tech had it at the moment. The ball took a couple of more bad bounces, and if you're a Tech man, you say bad bounces. If you're a Texas man, you said it was a true bounce, and Bragg made the recovery.
So Texas has the ball, and Shannon Kelly is the quarterback. Kelly gives off to his tailback, Anthony Byerly, and Byerly is stopped at the line of scrimmage. Coming up to make the tackle is James Johnson, number 40, the linebacker. Jerry Moore saw his Red Raiders get a couple of tough breaks in the first half.
This is a team that just has not had any good fortune all year, and the completed pass that was caught by the man Gay out of bounds on the play, and then the deflected passes were 14 points in the first half that somewhat doubtful.
Here's Shannon Kelly. Kelly again giving off to Byerly, moving the ball up to the 45. The Longhorns, with 42 seconds to go, have a 34-21 lead. But Stafford has been so impressive today, Coach, and this Texas football team certainly came out here to take charge this afternoon after taking that walloping by SMU.
And they did a very good job, and they did not turn over the ball after the bad experience last week of 6 turnovers against SMU.
So it's Texas 34, Texas Tech 21. We have 42 seconds left to play in the ball game, and a 3rd and 6.